This is Resident Evil 7. And in Resident Evil 7, there is an achievement to beat the game in under 4 hours. Doing so gets you some stuff, but I thought it was really interesting because after I did my initial playthrough of the game, I noticed that there was a lot of things that you could either optimize or skip through and kind of save a lot of time. And I thought it was cool that they Capcom kind of acknowledged that, yeah, you can get through this game pretty quick if you ignore the story and ignore the VHS tapes and all that. So, yeah, my goal here is I'm going to try and beat this in under 4 hours, which doesn't seem like it's going to be impossible. I'm going to be doing it on easy, and I've watched a speedrun of the game a couple times to kind of familiarize like how to optimize and move as fast as possible. The main thing is going to be bosses. They're the biggest RNG, or random... I forgot the exact term of RNG. But the only random thing in this game really are the bosses. Everything else is pretty standard. Like, things are always where they're going to be, which makes a under 4 hour run of this possible. Also, I'm going to be doing this on easy, and I'm going to have the Magnum, which will hopefully take down enemies really fast. And I'm going to be sprinting past most enemies if I can. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Obviously, there's spoilers. If you haven't played this game, I recommend don't watch this. Go, you know, play the game for yourself. And then come back and watch this, or if you're just watching it because you're curious. But the second I hit go is when I have under 4 hours. So what, and also from what I understand, if you pause, it doesn't count against you. So I may pause at one point. I'm going to try not to. I'm going to try and just barrel through the entire game. The only, there's only one part I'm actually kind of nervous about it, is later on in the game. But when you save, it saves your timestamp. So if you quit the game, and come back, it won't count your death. So if I die, I could just quit the game, come back out, and then load again, and then I'll be at my old timestamp. So if I run into any real trouble, I can always restart. I do have a cutoff in mind. Like, if I'm not at a certain time, by the time I get to the third jack fight, which I'll explain that when I get there. All right, here we go. Let's just do it. Just do it. I'm a little nervous about it. It's my first... I mean, it's not really a speed run, because it's not, you know, super fast. Maybe. It's, I mean, this is a part of the game. Like, they put an achievement in here specifically for it, so it's not like it's a speed run. Like, I think the current world record for this game on PC is like an hour and a half or an hour and 38 minutes, something like that. So I'm not trying for that. I'm just trying for under 4 hours. That's all I want. As far as I know, you can't skip any of this. All the cutscenes and all this stuff is unskippable. So I just kind of have to deal with it, which sucks because the first 30 minutes of this game, first 30 minutes to an hour is mostly cutscenes. But in the speedruns, I have noticed that they were able to kind of get to the first playable section in 15 minutes roundabout. So I don't know if I'll get that. I think it'll probably be closer to 30, but, having gone through this before, it helps. The other thing that helps is I'm not going to be watching any of the VHS tapes because I don't need to. The VHS tapes really just give you more story and show you things that are going to happen later in the game, and I already know what's going to happen. So,
stay away.
I don't need to worry about that. So that will save a huge bunch of time because for some reason, every time I load up a VHS tape, it takes forever on my Xbox. On PC, it goes super fast. I don't know why on Xbox it's so slow. So that will save, I think altogether will probably save like 15, 20 minutes. So the first goal for the first half of the speedrun is I just need to get through this scripted crap as fast as possible. I need to fight Mia as effectively as I can. She's tough because you have to get headshots on her with the gun you get early on. And my aiming isn't 100% great. But when I get the Magnum, that will help because body shots also work against enemies. But like I said, I'm trying to sprint past all these enemies as much as possible. I don't have the speed shoes either, which is something you get for beating Madhouse, the hard difficulty. So here we go. So a lot of this game is item collection and exploration. So if you cut all that out, it becomes a lot easier. I'm going to just grab items that are, you know, in my field of view. I'm not going to go out of my way to grab things. Health items, I'm trying to minimize the running around collecting things. So there we go. So now I'm in control. Timer starts. I'm going. There we go. So even as Ethan, the regular run cycle is actually not that slow. You go pretty quick, but you go even faster with the shoes. So, like I said, I'm not collecting any documents. I'm not looking at anything. I am just barreling through the game as fast as possible. So, it's also an easy, so it makes enemies kind of a joke. Which is intentional, because I don't want these enemies to cost me time. This slows me down on purpose. I can't move any faster because of Jack. There we go. We're sprinting. And thankfully, there's no cooldown on the sprint. You can just sprint all you want. At least as far as I know. I haven't run into a cooldown. There we go. Can't control how fast you crouch. There we go. I don't necessarily know if you need to pick up the purse and stuff. I don't know if there's a flag set on that for later in the game, but whatever. Okay, whatever. Trying to move as effectively as possible in this game. All right, into the house. All right, so it won't let me open this door until I... Okay. So I'm just running. Since I know where the secret entrance in the fireplace is, I don't need to mess around with watching the VHS tape, which again takes a lot of time. So I actually should have turned the brightness all the way up too, which is, there we go, which is actually super helpful. I should have done that, but oh well. Though if I pause, hold on, this doesn't cost me time. I'm going to turn the brightness all the way up because I need to be able to see everything. Okay, here we go. In case an enemy tries to block my path or something. Can I just fall? I think I could just fall down here. Nope. All right. Cost me a few seconds, but it's all right. Can't, because there's a scripted thing that happens here. I can't just fall down the hole, which is stupid. There we go. Oh, it's so scary. Okay. Once you go through this whole game, you realize how not scary it is. A lot of scripted things, and the enemies aren't that threatening. Like, even on normal, you can run through most of the enemies without much of a problem. Alright. Go, Ethan. Okay. Can't move any faster in water. So, like I said, the first hour of this game is just scripted stuff. It's not until, for people who played this game... It's not until you get tied to the dinner table is when you actually are in control, and that's when optimization and stuff really is key. Because what happens is, for this first part, it's like a rail shooter almost. You're just kind of going through the motions until you get to a certain point, and then when you're with the family is when the actual game starts, and then you can start doing that stuff. So... Here we go. I'm going to get to the first bit of story over here. There's key items you have to pick up. The whole thing is like knowing where the key items are and picking them up efficiently in the game. So this is the first key item. I need these bowl cutters. Run over here, get Mia. And again, menuing. That's another thing I'm not super great at is the menuing, because the menu in this is kind of janky. So that might cost me some time, but not too much overall. All right, Mia, wake up. Mia, wake up. I can't control the speed of this, so God, I'm just kind of sitting around.
Ethan?
Are you all right?
Oh, Mia.
What do you mean?
She looks normal.
You contacted me.
Don't worry, she's not crazy or anything. For no one who's... If you haven't played this game and you're watching, spoilers, obviously.
Did he see you?
Her hair looks so weird. When you turn the brightness up, her hair looks so fucked up.
Daddy's coming. We need to go.
Oh, Daddy's coming.
We need to go now.
It's zero threat as of right now. I can't run in front of her either. Because there's like this game employs this system of like flags where events will have to happen in a certain order for you to progress. So unfortunately, situations like this, Mia has to be in front of me. in order to progress to the next area and so forth and so on. So it doesn't save any time getting ahead of her. So you just got to be right on her, like just waiting. Like I can't even get past her, but I can just push here and wait until she's out of the way, and then go to the next door and wait till she gets to the door. Because all of this is just spooky atmosphere crap, but I don't care about that. I care about speed. The thing that will cost me the most are the boss fights, which I'm a little concerned with, especially Jack 3. That one's going to be tricky because one of the eyes is... get out of my way, Mia. Get out of my way. Can't even get past her. You gotta wait. But if you're right on her, you don't lose much time. Come on, Mia. Keep moving. Keep going. Keep going.
We have to talk. That message you sent me.
Not me. That wasn't me.
I don't know. I saw some runners who, again, I'm not speedrunning. I'm just trying to get the under 4 hours. But I saw some runners going for world record who would not look at the models. I don't know if that saves lag or whatever. This, honestly, the console version I'm playing on Xbox One, it didn't really... I didn't notice that much lag, honestly, when my normal playthrough... So I don't know if I just look at the wall or something, if that saves frames. I don't know. Again, I'm not at the point where I need to save frames. I'm just trying to save chunks of time. For example, like in boss fights or optimizing collecting items, getting the shotgun or not. I decided I'm not going to get the shotgun because I'll have the Albert. I'm just going to get the broken shotgun and then use the repair kit on that as a backup in case. It's complete safety stuff. Okay, Mia, come on. Come on, lady. You've caused so much problems in this story. So many problems. Alright, so she's gonna do her thing. I'm just gonna come over here.
I'm sure of it.
I'm just gonna hang out until the scripted thing happens. Oh, there's adults. Freaky. She's gotta do her whole spiel before it happens. So I'm just hanging out over here to activate it as soon as possible. I'm sure of it. Yes, yes, yes. I know that you're sure of it. Okay, look at Mia. Come over here. Look at this doll. There we go.
No, leave me alone.
That's what we wanted. All right. So now we're going back to the house, and we're back in control somewhat. So this is the next section where I could lose some time if I'm not careful. Okay. So I'm running down over here. I need to activate. Actually, I'm going to grab this health again in case. And it would be kind of dumb not to grab it. Okay. So I'm going to come over here. You're going to hear banging on the door. That's Mia. So I'm going to go. Also, when you hit a wall, I notice it stops you like dead. It ruins your sprint. Opening it. Here we go. Oh, there's Mia. What you doing? Why are you crawling on the floor? Again, I can't control any of this. This is just happening. She does not look well. Oh, God. Okay, so I can't control what Mia's doing right now. She's just there. I gotta resist! So I just hit right trigger, like, mad. It doesn't matter. Nothing you do matters right now. It's all scripted. It's all rail shootery type crap. So you can... I'm actually going to run at her because it will start. A lot of this is when I meet enemies that are like scripted, I'm just going to run at them just to save as much time as possible. Yeah, so again, it's just, I can't really do anything. Go away, Mia. Go away. So she's going to get all like, oh, I'm okay now. Everything's okay. Okay.
Who's her? Back
if you haven't played this game, oh, sorry if you get spooked. If you get spooked, sorry. I've played through this. It has no effect on me whatsoever. So I'm just gonna be running right into jump scares with reckless abandon. But I won't warn anybody because I think it's fun to get spooked. Oh yeah, I have to use the first aid because it's a prompt, and then. I think after I use it. Come on, Mia. All right, so I have to run, I guess, over here. Again, the flag system of this game is weird. I don't know when it decides. Here we go. When things happen, it's annoying. All right. Oh no! All right, so this is the first thing of RNG that I gotta be careful with, where how I handle this fight. So here we go, first fight. So I missed two hits already right there, so I'm a little bummed about that. I think I need to be in front of her to get the final hit. I'm not 100% sure, but... Bop! Okay. That was good. That wasn't bad. I didn't lose a lot of time. So, I need to run to the phone, pick up the phone, come back. I'm totally ruining this for people. Sorry. Well, who cares? Oh, actually, that's a really good spot for her to land, too. I'm gonna save a lot of time on the coming back. Ring. Ring. There we go. This is Zoe. Hi, Zoe. Hi, hello, everyone. She's cool. She's a cool lady.
What the fuck is going on?
We'll learn more about her later. I'm not going to be doing the Zoe ending for anyone who's played this. It's slower, so the Mia ending's faster because I don't have to fight Mia again. So, go, go, go! Oh, she's gone. But look at that. That's amazing placement. So I got the axe. Here we go. I'm going to go up to... I need the fuse first. So in order to get the fuse, you got to run over here. Remember that locked door before? You may not remember it because I kind of ran past it. But this right here. Yep. And then we're going to get the fuse. Fuse is important. I can't continue to fight Mia. And then we're going to get to our first save section as well over here. All right, come on. Let's go, go, go. Got to go fast. Hey, Mia. What's up? Talk to you in a sec. So, yeah, it's important because I need to get up to the attic, and the only way to do it... Well, why would I shut the door? It's teaching you how to shut a door. See, this is what I'm talking about, menu. No! That's not what I wanted. There we go. Menuing will be a problem because doing it, it's much easier on a... Oh, hey, Mia.
Okay.
On a mouse and keyboard than with a stick, because the stick will fly around the goddamn menu and make it awful. Again, this is another thing I can't speed up. It's just happening. I don't even know if I hit right trigger a lot. If it will work. I'll try. I don't think it does anything. Mia's got to go get a thing, as you'll see in a second. And something needs to happen before I can take this off. It's all to build suspense. It's really great for the first time you play it, because you're like, what the fuck's going on? Did I do something wrong? Could I have stopped this from happening? Could I have taken this out of my hand sooner? See, it's all bullshit. Like, it's all scripted. This is supposed to happen. Don't worry. My hand is supposed to come off. And you assume Mia's gonna come kill you, but then she just decides to leave. She's like, no. Oh, Jesster 32388. So she just leaves. She fucks off. There she goes. And you can follow the smoke. I don't need my hand. I can pick it up if I need to. But I don't know why. I did it the first time I played the game. So I'm going to open the stairs. See, again, it's little optimizations that makes this run. Okay. And then I'm going to do new save for this. There we go. I'm saving. Costing a few seconds, but whatever. It's important to do it in certain sections. Okay. I'm not getting that VHS tape. It's pointless. My fiance is sitting next to me watching the chat. I need to get the gun because that's the only way to beat Mia. Oh, actually, no, that's not true. You can use the axe, but I don't think it's faster.
Okay.
I could get some safety bullets here. You know what? I'm going to go get them. I was debating not getting the safety bullets, but I'm going to do it because, again, my aim is not 100%, you know, great in this game. So this is the first big thing RNG. So here we go. What does someone say? Yeah, pretty much. Okay, so this is bad. This is a bad... Oh, shit. I forgot. See, already. Oh, God, Mia. Already a bad fight. Like, already. Yep. Yeah, this is bad. This is bad. All right. We're good now. All right.
You were always watching me.
It's better to get her behind these pillars. Take your time. Line up your shots. It's better to wait and line up these shots than... because reloading takes for fucking ever. Come on. I should have counted how many shots it takes to bring me down. I didn't do that. Okay, there we go. So Mia's down. We did it. Woo! We did it. We got through the first big thing of randomness. And I can't make this next thing progress. It just happens. So we're getting into it. We're doing it. Come on. Do it. Do it. Come on, Jack. Where you at, buddy? There's the audio cue. There he is.
Welcome to the family, son.
Welcome to the family, everybody. Okay. Oh, Mia, I wonder if we will see her again at any point in this game. She looks pretty dead. She may or may not be dead.
Kartunsky.
Eight shots? Okay. Yeah, I should have timed that out. There were things I should have done in this playthrough before I started time out certain things, but I didn't, because fuck it. 4 hours, that's a pretty... I think. It's a pretty wide berth. The big thing is... there's the Resident Evil theme, for those who didn't know. That's the OG Resident Evil, or at least another kind of homage to it. So that was the first big thing of randomness. I'm very happy that went better than I thought.
Don't you die on us now? You
have I think that's Zoe, but Zoe's not in this scene. Is that Zoe who's stapling my hand? It looks like women's feet. That's got to be Zoe. I can't look up. Nope. I don't know if that's Zoe. So I'm really annoyed. I don't know why Capcom decided to do this on replays. Why they didn't allow you to skip cutscenes. If they did, this would it would blow the speedrunning community wide open if you could skip cutscenes. Like I said, the current record is an hour 38, and like, imagine if you could skip those cutscenes. It would take out at least 10, 15 minutes probably out of the whole thing. Because I can do nothing during this whole section. I am just sitting here. Which is great for story and atmosphere, but... That's Lucas. That's Grandma. She's totally normal. Don't worry about it. Jack and Marguerite. Marguerite's my favorite. She's my... Another fight that I'm very worried about is Marguerite. Oh, yeah, his hand got cut off. Don't worry about that, though. Marguerite is another fight and section I'm a little worried about, but on easy, apparently she's a joke. At least her stealth section, so that's another thing, is whether or not there's a item you can get in her section that is not absolutely necessary because you'll have the magnum. So I may just skip it, the flamethrower. It helps with her bugs, but you can just destroy the hive. Who, Mike? How's her... Yeah, I love you too, Mike. Thank you. Oh no, you don't have to. Sarah hates this game, my fiance. So she's just modding the chat a little bit. Yeah, I can't do anything. So this, which it shouldn't count for time, I swear. Oh, the phone! If on VR, that's the only reason those things exist, I think. There's a couple fake outs like that where it gets right in your face. And if you're playing on VR, I'm sure that's so spoopy. But on this, it's not really scary. So it looks like they're going that way, right? Like out that door. Jack is actually going to be over there. So I need to... Okay, so... Shout out to Mike. Oh yeah, Marguerite and Jack? I don't know. Well, they're totally normal people. Okay, so... This might look scary. It may not look like I know what I'm doing, but I've watched a couple speedruns do this, so I'm going to try it. I'm going to attempt it. Okay, so there's Jack. He's a jerk. He sees me. Okay, he's going to throw me. Oh. That... Oh, nice. Okay, I'm running. Now I got the key. That was the big thing. So I just needed the key. Hopefully he gives up his chase is what I'm hoping for. The A thing. I got to work on that. The doors. How people get those doors open so fast. Menuing. Fuck menuing. Go, 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 go. All right. Woo. And again, saved a bunch of time there. While I'm crouching, I cannot move faster, which sucks. I'm going to ignore the antique coin. I don't care. I'm not going to get any of the antique coin stuff. Our first objective is to get the three dog heads to get out of the main house. And I have to fight Jack to get that. So, here we go. Alright, so this is the next save section. I'm actually going to save right now. And I'm also going to do some boxing right here. This is actually one of the first instances of me using the item box. Because I need my gun. Need my gun. This Albert is essential. I'm also going to take the defense coin and the secret of defense just because why not? Okay, cool. I'm also going to grab a herb, and I'm going to make a... Yeah, it's teaching us, people. Okay. And I think there's ammo somewhere in here. No. Okay. I'm going to use some goof juice now. Ah, fuck. I'm not even going to bother. Okay. All right. So the next thing is we need to go to the garage and fight Jack. The phone is over here. Actually, no, it's not. I'm a dummy. Already wasting time. Already wasting time. The phone's in here. Oh, it's over here, right? Oh, shit. I don't remember where the phone is. Oh, no. This is disastrous. I may actually restart the save. Where the fuck is the phone? Oh, it's in the... This happened to me the first time I played. All right, fuck that. All right, hold on. No. We're not wasting... That is a time waste. I am not accepting. This happened to me the first time I played, too. We are going to load that game again. Because... That's why I did this. Because it resets the timer back to when you saved. From when that save file is. So that is a godsend for this type of run. Because this happened to me the first time I played, too. I ran around the house for like 5 minutes trying to find that fucking phone. It's in the laundry room. So I got to do the menuing again. I got to combine the cam again, and then we'll be good to go. That's probably going to happen a couple times in this playthrough. I'm a failure. Look at the loading times. The loading times on Xbox One are just atrocious. They are atrocious. Look at this. I don't know why they're so long. I lost two viewers because I fucked up. This is not a legit speedrun. This is, if I was trying for a record, this would probably be a reset. But because I learned that when you reload a save, it goes back to the time that you that was in that save file, then yeah, I'm not no sweat off my back. But I would prefer not to do this. It probably would actually save more time if I would have just answered the phone. But whatever, choices. I've made them. I'm living with them. Oh my god, why is this so slow? I have it on an external hard drive, right? So you would assume it would run faster. I play Overwatch on it, I play other games on it, and it runs a lot better. But okay, here we go. Now we're back in it. We're playing the feud. Okay, so okay, I need... What? Oh yeah, you can make clips. Okay, I don't need the house map. I don't need any of this. Okay, here we go. So the phone's gonna ring the second I step out. Like a dick. Okay, let's talk to Zoe. And then we're gonna go to the garage and deal with Papa.
Zoe, right? What the fuck are you?
I love how Ethan is so like nonplussed about all this. He seems very calm throughout this whole playthrough. It's very weird that he is so calm about the whole thing. And all that told me was about the codex, which honestly doesn't do much right now. The codex is more important for later. I'm gonna use some goof juice here in a sec. Okay, so I'm gonna run down this hall and run back, and then by that point the next cutscene trigger should happen. All right.
I'm watching because I hate scary games, but I'm thinking I'm going to Redbox it to try the VR.
Oh yeah.
Jump scares out the way.
Yeah.
So I can sleep at night.
Absolutely. I really like, that was another reason why I wanted to do this, was because I wanted to, you know, if people wanted to watch the game without playing it, there seems to be a big conversation happening now with people who are not really into scary games, but they want to try it out because everyone keeps talking about it. And I think things like this are great for people who want to check it out. I'm really glad that I'm helping people, you know, decide if they want to play this game or not by doing this. God, where is this guy? I'm not restarting, don't worry. This is normal. There's a cutscene trigger that has to happen. I'm just going to run down this hall and run back. This is the main big time loss in this game.
You can totally remove that tape by hand.
I know, right? And I can kill that guy, but I'm not going to. I'm saving the Magnum ammo for the fight coming up, which actually, if I do it right, I won't need it, really. I'll be using the knife mainly. All right, there he is. So I just had to run down the hall. So again, another cutscene trigger that I can't skip. Here we go. These actually, after the Jack 1 fight, will be not as bad. Not until we get to the farmhouse, the testing site, when the unskippable cutscene crap will start up again. But yeah, I'm not really playing this in the optimal way, because like, you know, lights off, headphones on, brightness, you know, adequate. No, I'm just doing this for speed only. And I really can't save time until... Excuse me, then... What's that? You think that guy's going to die? Well, let's start a poll, everybody. Will this police officer, this friendly police officer, die in the next 30 minutes? Poll starts now, and it'll end soon. This is also funny. Ethan asked for his gun. Markiplier brought this up. He asked for his gun... And of course the cop is going to say no. If I was in this situation, I don't know if I would ask for his gun. I would be like, hey, no, we're standing right here. Call in backup right now, and we're going to stand here until backup arrives. Like, I'm not meeting you in the fucking garage. Like, no, no, no. I don't trust going anywhere.
A fucking pocket knife?
Yeah, like, there are certain cutscene... Okay. So for that question, are there certain things that you... Like, you have to hit certain cutscene triggers, yes. You have to... Oh, fuck. Okay, there we go. There are certain cutscene triggers you have to hit in order to advance the plot and the story. Most of them involve items. So you have to pick up certain items or experience things in a certain order for it to count. That's the way the game flags important events. So for this fight, it's interesting. There's two ways I can handle it. The one speedrun I saw, I'm going to try for that. There's a method where you can get the car keys, get in the car, and start running Jack over. If I mess it up... Okay, pull over. He died. whoever voted, he died. Okay, so first things first. I need his car key.
Please give me your gun.
So let's see if I did it right. Okay, I did. Cool. So this saves a bit of time, I believe. I'm just gonna run into Jack a bunch of times.
Bring it on!
I think this saves time. At least the one. Wow, textures are great. Oh, there you are, Jack. Come here. I believe this saves time overall. Other than the other thing would be just running around him with a knife and stabbing him with a knife. There are no cues. It's just okay. There comes Jack. So there's no cues per se. It's just that having played the game once already, I already know what the cues are. You know. I know what key items are. Like, for example, there's a gun over here that I don't need to pick up, but it's faster if I do pick it up because there's an animation. Oh, okay, Jack, thanks. Jack's really nice. He's a really nice host, as you can see. I'm fine.
Fine, there's just blood.
I'm fine.
It's good.
I'm fine. Yeah, everything's good. So, Jack is not having a good time, but he's fine. Jack's good. I think I can shoot him now. I'm not 100% sure. Oh, no. The ladder hasn't come down yet. Okay. So I got to wait until Jack's on fire. Wait until he comes out of the car. All right. So it should be two shots, and we're good.
Oh, boy.
One. I might be wrong, though. Two. No? Three? Oh, there we go. All right, two shots. I knew it. All right. So, Jack is... Do you think Jack's dead? Let's do another poll. I don't have a lot of ammo right now. He's fine. He's a little sunburned. A little sunburned. All right. Ladder's down. Oh, let's pick that up. Why not? I don't need it, but whatever. It does make this go faster because the gun's already in my hand. If you come over here, it takes a second for it to register. Okay, that's fine. He's fine. Okay, heading up. I'm going to actually put that gun away because I don't need it at all. It is completely useless when I have the Magnum. Because the Magnum takes the same ammo as the... come on, give me. Okay. The Magnum takes the same ammo as the regular handgun, so I don't need it. So I'm actually going to run back to the save room, drop that off, and continue on. So right now, we've dealt with Jack 1. That's the second boss of the game. So we're going to real quick run into... He's not going to be patrolling here now, which is nice. Run back to the save room. I'm going to save and drop the regular handgun off. Yeah, skip that. So, yeah. I know this costs time. I know saving costs time, but it in the long run, it will be helpful in case I fuck up. Okay. So I'm going to get rid of this handgun because I don't need it. It is completely useless. And I'm going to reload this one. All right. Moving on. We are moving on. So, next thing we're going to do is we're going to collect 3 bullheads that will unlock the front door. And also another thing I'm going to be doing is... Come on. Oh, that's right. I keep forgetting you have to push doors open in this game. So I need to get 3 bullheads. And there's also a phone call from Zoe I need to do.
Did my daddy give you a hard time?
Oh, your dad is fine. He's great. He's a good gentleman. That Jack. Jack Baker. He's so hospitable. It's nice family. I need to pay attention. Like, I was looking at my phone, but the second this ends, I need to move. All right, here we go. All right, so I'm not going to be getting the shotgun in that room right there. Reason being, I don't need it. I have this Magnum, and I'm going to get the broken shotgun up here. Hey, Grandma! Totally normal. All right, so I'm going to be running. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get the first bullhead. And it's in this book right here. Boom. Got it. All right. I'm also going to pick up the... I don't need the gunpowder. All right. So we're going to deal with Jack again here in a moment. He's pretty easy to run away from. Actually, before I do that, I'm actually going to do some item scavenging real quick. Just for some bullets. And then that's all I need. Okay. So I need this block to do the puzzle. The other thing I need to be careful of is my item space. There we go. Oh, he's not dead! Surprise! He's fine. Look, it's regrowing. It's fine. So this is another thing of RNG is Jack can be a real dick and run the left way, but he didn't, so... Alright, see you later, Jack. He won't be a problem till later. So we're gonna keep moving. So the other thing I'm going to do real quick, I've noticed speedrunners do this, and I'll just do what they do because why not? The second bullhead actually is in the living room, and you need this thing to get it. Jack will be in the other room, though, if I try and go get it. But honestly, he's not that much of an issue with this Magnum especially. I'm just going to run in there. Oh, bye. Mike did said that? Oh, cartoon. Oh, okay. Thanks for watching. Appreciate it. I don't know who that is either, but he's a nice person. Oh, okay. Okay. So we're gonna put this here. That's gonna attract Jack, but Jack's a jerk. Okay, cool. Jack will probably be in the hallway. Probably. Let's see. I hear him.
Where in the hell you think you're going to, son?
Oh, I got, oh, sweet! That was really good luck on my part. Okay. There's a trigger where he can burst through the door. And thankfully I missed it. That's very lucky. Okay, so I need to do this as fast as possible. It sucks. Now's not the time for that. Why? Why? Jack, you dick face. Wow, he's never chased me through there before. I think 2 hits will bring him down. There we go. Come on. Really? There we go. Pain in the ass. All right. Wow, that was a first. Oh, my God. Again, doing this on a console is awful because I got... Oh, my God. There we go. Close enough. Now we got to go downstairs. We got to go to the dissection room and fight Jack one more time. And then get the final bullhead. All right, there we go. Again, I might do some item collecting in here just to grab. I think there's some ammo in here as well as health. If I will try, I'm only going to pick up items that I can see, like, or in a drawer that's not super out of the way. That crow door, interestingly enough, the crow door. There we go. The crow door. Oh, my knife's up the wrong one. It is. Has a grenade launcher in there and stuff, but if you wait till the end of the game, it just gives it to you. Yeah, it just gives you it. I think there's just a lockpick. All right. So first thing we're gonna do is go. Oh, I'm not gonna even fight the molded. Not even gonna bother. I can't be bothered to fight the molded right now. The downstairs, I may have to fight a couple molded, which is why I'm gonna save right here. If I die at any point, just a heads up for people watching. If I die at any point, I'm gonna be reverting back to a save. So that'll take some time, but I'm trying to not die. Ah, fuck, why did I do that? Oh, whatever. Okay, let's take a look at our inventory real quick. Is there anything we don't need? We technically, no, we're good. We're good. We'll just stick with it. We technically don't need the dog heads right now, but I mean, I'm not gonna be picking up too much else, so. Okay, so this part is also a little tricky. Just because I need to get through these next couple rooms without taking too much damage. Because I only have a couple health. Hey, buddy. All right. So he's in my way. Okay. Took one more bullet than it should have. I think two headshots brings them down. Oh, is this the... Yes. Okay. Oh. Okay. So I already know the puzzle. So I'm just gonna do the puzzle real quick. You have to open two of these, and it opens this one over here. What I saw, you can just stand here. Okay. You can just kind of stand next to them and get the key. There we go, and run past them. So we're just gonna do that. Then we're gonna go in here. There are two molded in here that I may. And I can run past. There's two molded in here that I can run past. Maybe not, because I gotta use a key. Okay. Oh, this is bad. Oh, this is bad news bears. Uh-oh. That's alright. That's alright. I got some health for this situation. I don't have a shot. Oh, hey. I just need this guy, really. Really? This magnum is not nearly as good as I thought it was gonna be. Losing a bunch of time. Oh man, there's just a party going on in here. Okay, with shotgun ammo, I don't need that. It should be okay, actually. Come on. Okay, I took a hit. Oh, okay, I took two hits. And I have no health. That's alright, there might be a healing item. Yep, there's a herb. That should be good enough. And shotgun shells, which I don't have. Should be okay for this fight. Okay. I think there's a healing item also on the other side. So again, I'm going to lose some time. But there might be something in here too. Open. Quick. Nope. Oh, you double tap the door and that's how you open it. Okay. I know I can start the fight right now. But again, if I die, I'm going all the way back to the save. At the beginning, it's just gunpowder. There's no health. Okay, fine. Yeah. I don't know. I don't know.
Who are you?
I might be Scott, but no, maybe. Oh, hi. Okay. So this fight is annoying. So there's some healing stuff down here, actually. Come here, Jack. It's just lining up these shots is always a pain. So the whole thing with this is just to hurt him enough until he goes for his thing. Lip and boom. Okay. He should go for the, And basically all I'm going to be doing is standing right next to him, grabbing the chainsaw. Come on, give it. Okay.
Ooh,
As long as you have the chainsaw up, I believe you're good. Huh? Oh, nice. Thank you. You're welcome. Okay. And then we're going to do this. Oh, the engine stopped. So that's scripted. I can't stop it. Fine. I know what I'm doing. Okay. Okay. So that's why it's good to slash, because it blocks its kicks sometimes. Yeah, that one wasn't blocked, but it's fine. There you go. And then we're gonna go right here. We're doing fine. We're doing fine. There we go. I believe that's the end. Alright. No, maybe not. There we go. That's the end. Woo! Alright. Oh, sorry. Yeah, it's pretty gross. I was concentrating. I wasn't talking much. But there we go. That's Jack, Jack 2. I guess technically. I got a heavy duty thing. Open it, you dick. I gotta wait for him to die. Get this open. So the only thing I'm actually gonna go out of my way for, is, the other shotgun. The broken shotgun. Let's just go. I didn't get the crow key, I don't think, though. I don't think I did. Thinking, because I'm like, where do I get it? I'm actually going to put away the shotgun shells because I don't need them right now. I don't have a shotgun. I'm gonna use the three heads. Yeah. Okay. I think we're good. Hi, Grandma. You have to get it from the. I didn't even get the scorpion key. Huh. I'm hoping I didn't miss something. I feel like I missed something. So I don't remember coming all this way to get out of the house after you beat Jack. You know? I don't remember going back through here.
Hey, Mommy.
And I technically don't need the scorpion key for anything, really, but it's just a shortcut, but I don't. All right, so let's get out of the house. All right, there we go. We're out of the house. I don't think I got the scorpion key. Where the hell do you get the scorpion key? I'm gonna go save real quick. I am like perplexed right now as to where you get the scorpion key. I don't want to look it up because that costs time. Well, I could pause. No, I'm not gonna do that. That's a broken handgun. We don't need it. Yeah, please. Because I'm just like, I feel like you don't need any of that. Oh, Zoe. Gotta do his phone call with Zoe.
You made it. You're the first I've ever seen make it.
I might check the time after this just to see where we're at. I think we should be an hour.
Yes. Now listen carefully.
It's in the incinerator room?
My family and I. Our bodies are.
But I mean, I don't really need it, I guess. I'd get it for the broken shotgun.
You can find the scorpion.
And the same goes for me.
Is there a way to get it out?
We have a large piece of
fuck me, I completely missed that.
As long as you're not too far gone.
Do I really need the broken shotgun?
But I have a feeling my mother has hidden some inside the old house somewhere.
So if we get this thing.
Pretty much. It's pretty much Texas Chainsaw meets Resident Evil. I feel like I'm gonna need that model shotgun. Yeah, I walked right because there were. Remember the all the molded that was around me? There was like four molded. It's in the middle there, but I was panicking. Fuck me. Oh, I know exactly where it is. I might need the shotgun though. All right, detour. I'm losing some time here, but it's fine. Let's see where we're at with time, actually. 44 minutes. I think we're good. I can't believe I missed that. I know exactly where it is. Hold on. This is why I will never be a speedrunner, like a legit speedrunner, because the things you have to take into account, the mental math you have to play with yourself is just crazy. Okay, so this is where the croaky is. I was running around panicked like a goober the first time through here. I was just worried about not dying. The croaky is actually not in any of these rooms we've seen. It's actually through here. And there's a molded in there, which sucks. The actually only reason for this room is to get the croaky. I feel like I'm gonna have to open these because if I would have just came over here the first time, it would have been so much nicer. He's gonna fall out of the ceiling. I'm gonna run right past him. Oh, he didn't. Did I get ammo? I did. I have so much ammo. Okay, cool. The Magnum, I believe, just takes handgun ammo, if I'm not mistaken. So it makes this playthrough much, much simpler. All right. I'll save at the trailer again now that I have the croaky and I can actually open up this shortcut. And then I actually need to go get the broken shotgun. The reason why I'm going to get the broken shotgun is because I will have it as a backup. Because I'll be picking up shotgun ammo like throughout the playthrough. So that one's useless. If you can just get the broken shotgun, you might as well just repair it. So there's no enemies chasing me right now is also another reason why now is a good time to go and get this thing. I could see what's in here real quick. It doesn't cost me any time. It's first aid. That's strong first aid too, so that's useful. All right. Open. Okay. Let's get the model shotgun or the broken shotgun. There it is. Thank you. I'm also going to check real quick for... Yep, I want that. I'll take the chem fluid because I can make some more shotgun cells because we'll have a shotgun now in a moment. Ran out of space too, so good thing we're going back. Okay, I need some space to pick up the repair kit, though. There is a gun repair kit, and it's not a lot of people know where it is. So I'm going to show you. The few people viewing right now, you'll get a nice surprise. Pro tips, where the gun kit is. But I actually need to drop some stuff off. Excuse me, probably the shotgun ammo. Because we're about to go deal with Marguerite, and that section can be brutal. Let's save real quick. Marguerite can be brutal, especially her boss fight. So I want to at least have some stuff. Let's put the shotgun ammo away for right now. Alright. There's also a broken handgun on that bed I just passed. But again, we don't need it for the purposes of this playthrough. So underneath the house right here, there is a gun repair kit. The first of two, which you can use to either repair the handgun or the broken shotgun. Oops. We're going to use it to repair the shotgun. Because the shotgun is the best thing ever. It is really, really strong. And it's good. That's all you need to know. Alright, so we're going to use the gun repair kit on the shotgun. Boom, now we have a power-flash shotgun. We're also going to put away that chem fluid for now because we don't have anything to use for it. So I'm going to take the shotgun shells. Need those. And now I have two pretty powerful weapons. The scorpion key I'll keep because I think I need it. Alright, and then let's load this thing. It's loaded, ready to go. Let's get that animation out of the way too. Time save. Okay, let's go face down Marguerite. Now, what you're supposed to do in this section is you're supposed to get a flamethrower and burn these, like, nests and all this bullcrap. We're going to try to avoid doing that by using the Magnum here to destroy the bug nest instead of using the flamethrower. That's kind of the goal here, is we're just going to try and it's basically, in a way, skipping a whole section of this stage. But one thing I do need, one thing I do need is a crank. So the nest that I have to take out is right there. So that, step. I need to reload before it heals. Step. Reload. There we go. All right. So now doing that, it takes care of the whole section of having to get the flamethrower. We don't even need it right now. Need this. Hi, there's Mia. That wastes time. We're not going to talk to Mia. What's this? No, antique coin. I don't have enough space. That's a problem. That'll be fine. All right. So go through this door. Okay. There's Marguerite. Marguerite is an issue. So basically her thing is you can't let her see you or else she'll attack you or whatever. So the goal here, I can't pick up anything. That's all right. The goal here is to sneak around without Marguerite finding me. The only thing I really need to do, I need to get outside for... All right, so I'm sneaking around because I could run around Marguerite, but I'd rather play it a little safe. Fuck it, I'll just run around. There's Marguerite. Bye-bye, Marguerite. And then we need to go outside and grab the crank. Which I believe... No, that's the flamer part. The crank is... Oh, it's below the basement. Right. I went the wrong way. It's fine. Everything's fine. Marguerite's not that big of an issue. Hi, Marguerite. Oh, Marguerite, move, Marguerite. I can just go outside. It's fine. She's having fun back there. Marguerite's having a good time. I just hide outside a second. She'll forget I'm out here. Yeah. So I went the wrong way, so that cost me about probably 2 or 3 minutes. Marguerite's hanging out in the thing. These guys are annoying. Yeah. They deal a lot more damage than they should. I'm not wasting any ammo on these assholes. Okay. I could stagger Marguerite. I could take her out. But it's faster just to let her do her thing and walk around. Actually, I should have just went in while she was here. That saves time. Yeah, she's right there. I just need to get past the doorway. Whatever. I just need to get past the doorway. Actually, I'll play it safe here. She comes in and then comes back out. So I'm losing some time, but I feel like this is the safer route to dealing with Marguerite. Yeah, there she goes. So oh, what are you doing? Why are you coming in here? She clears the door. I can get past her. Bye, Marguerite. She's kind of blind. You can walk right past her on easy, and she will not acknowledge your existence. So we're actually going to go do a save here for safety. And you get a backpack, which is super helpful for the rest of the run. Save real quick. I can carry more ammo. Right now, I think I have enough to kill Marguerite in the boss fight, but because I haven't used much ammo, which is nice. But health is always a concern. So I need to get the crank, come back out to that same section. So I have to deal with Marguerite one more time. Chem fluid. Ain't got ammo important. I'm going to put the chem fluid away because I don't need it. I have to deal with Marguerite's stealth one more time, and then we're good. We go to the Marguerite boss fight. Alright, I have 2 strong. I should have enough to kill Marguerite then, pretty easily. Once we get past Marguerite, smooth sailing, I think, to the end of the game. There's really only one other section that I'm kind of, nervous about. It's near the end. It's the ship section. If you've played this, you know what I'm talking about. That's the only thing I'm super concerned with, because I only played through it once, and I watched the speedrun of it, but little concerned with the ship section. It's easy to get turned around in there, but we should be okay. We should be good. So we're getting past Marguerite. I'd actually prefer one more healing item, ideally. All right. So we need this crank, and the crank is down here. When you first come in here, you assume something horrible is going to happen because, you know, it looks terrifying and you're like, oh god, so scary. Nope, don't want that. But nothing happens. You literally just walk in and take the crank and then leave. And so, well, those bugs are annoying, but hopefully he won't attack. So the crank is actually super useful. It only is super useful in two sections of the game, this section and near the end. I'm actually going to use the crank here. Creates a shortcut. So now I need to go back outside to where I was earlier, and where I ran past Marguerite and raise a bridge over there and then come back and then... Yes, she's upstairs. She's not upstairs. As a matter of fact, she's here. I'm going to just go with it and assume Marguerite is on the other side. She was. Sweet. Oh, hi, Marguerite. Don't worry about me. Don't worry about me. She is literally blind. She's such a... Like, she has a horrible, horrible mouth on her, too. You know what? Since I'm running this way, I'm actually going to grab some extra healing items. I was going to avoid this room completely, but... I might actually, before I fight Marguerite, I might actually do some chem stuff. I need to get closer to this. It's doing nothing, though. Oh, there it goes. Okay, now we're good. Wow, that took, I think because I was hitting the shell, I wasn't hitting the actual thing. Alright. I'm gonna have to use one more health item. Before the Marguerite fight, actually, I'll use it now. Oh, you use so much ammo to do that. That's a bummer. That's a bummer. All right, there's the croaky. Now we can. Oh, why did I pick up that burner fuel? Completely useless. So, I don't know. It's all right. We'll start the Marguerite fight now. She used the shotgun for this fight. Hi, Marguerite. Bye, Marguerite. Excuse me. This fight is kind of a gimme, so I'll just save when we get back to the trailer. It's not really a fight, what I'm about to do. It's more of I need an item. There's an item that I need to progress the story. So, yeah, I have to. It was faster to go the other way. But whatever, I did it. It's done. I fucked up, but it's fine. Okay, there's Marguerite. Shows back up like a real jerk. Now, again, this isn't really a fight, as is I need an item, and they needed a clever way to create a shortcut, and blah, blah, blah. So, I'm going to... Yep. Basically, I'm just shooting Marguerite a few times, and then that will be that. I gotta wait for her to show her dumb face. Oh, that was really good. All right, let's get out of here. So the item that I need is Marguerite's lantern. But unfortunately, I can't grab it from her as she's laying there. I don't know why. Because game. So I need to come in here... I need to open this, and then I'm going to get a phone call from Zoe. See, that's the one time this thing comes into effect. Oh, it's creepy. It's a creepy baby. So I got to read this, and then I'm going to get a phone call from Zoe. And now, once with the phone call, I can go and start the Marguerite fight.
Did he find a serum?
I just got done dealing with your mom. All
right, I'm going to take a sip of water real quick.
Wish you could have
some water.
Sorry about that.
Sorry.
I haven't found any. But I did find out we need to make one.
Okay.
D-series head and an arm.
So basically what Zoe's telling me is I need to find a head and an arm of this D-series. Whatever that means. Mystery, mystery, mystery.
Have you searched the whole house?
And then I need to...
I still need to check the second floor here.
All right.
Create a serum for Zoe, because she's infected by the same thing that her parents are infected by. So in order to progress, I need to activate another bullshit thing. This thing. I have to go. Oh, it needs a thing. Okay. So now I can go down and start the next phase. I'm running in here just again to get. I thought there was items. Oh, shotgun. Perfect. All right. We should be good for the Marguerite fight. I have less than ideal handgun ammo, but health items are on point. All right, so I can't go down there until she does this. Marguerite, you know, she's got some secrets. She's got some secrets to protect. This is probably the most annoying boss fight in the game.
That's special.
Yeah, again, Ethan, nonplussed. He's seen everything. He's like, ugh, gross, right? Am I right? It's shit like that. But there is plenty of ammo during the Marguerite fight, so I should be okay. But I'm going to be doing a safety save there. Either A, if I die, or if the fight takes a little too long, I can just revert the save. So I'm going to run back here. I'm going to actually create another... Ooh, what was that? Was that? Strong template. I'm going to make another strong health kit. Because I think I have an herb. Oh, there's something underneath the trailer as well. Some shotguns. Just stuff that I remember. Like, you know, that I'm going to stop and get... So let's save real quick. That's the right one, yeah. And then we're gonna go find Marguerite, but let me do some item management real quick. We're gonna drop off the scorpion key because we're not gonna need that, I don't think, ever again. Let's drop off the burner fuel because we didn't even pick up the burner. Let's combine to make the super strong. Oh, I can make another one? No. Yep, that's all good. Okay. So now we're going for the Marguerite fight. Marguerite! This fight is... it is a fight. It's probably the most annoying out of all the fights in the game. Again, I'm going in with... No. I'm going in with less ideal Magnum ammo because that's going to be the main damage dealer. But I think I'll waste my shotgun first and then lay into her with the Magnum. Hopefully that will put her down. This fight can eat up a lot of time, so I'll check my status after. The fight starts when I go up the stairs, so it gives me a sec to kind of pillage down here. Yeah, that's what I'm looking for. Kind of pillage around and look, make sure I have all the items I need. So now I have 13 shots with the Magnum. That might be enough to put her down. Most bosses go down pretty quickly with the Magnum, like 3 or 4 shots, but Marguerite's tricky because you have to hit her in a very specific spot. Nope, I don't want that. For her to go down. So right now I'm just oh god, spiders. It doesn't matter. It's fine. Okay, here we go. Start the Marguerite fight. Okay, Marguerite. Blip. Blip. Alright. I should have used the shotgun. Because I just wasted 2 Magnum shots, but whatever. Okay, so the reason why this is the most random fight in the game is she can appear anywhere she fucking feels like it. She is crawling on the ceiling. She's crawling through holes. Like, everywhere. So basically, I have to keep an eye. That's another reason why I turned the brightness up, so I can see her. Because the second she pops out, I want to start doing damage. Ideally, I'd be doing damage to her... her nether regions, because that's where her weak point is. But her head also will work. If I stand still long enough, I think she'll just come to me. I hear her moving around. I hear her. Where are you, Marguerite? There she is. So, I want to shoot that, her little love rump down there. It's fine. Damage, it's fine, because again, I'm an easy, and I have the defensive coin and stuff, so,
Ew.
Yeah, she's got a little issue down there. The other problem with Marguerite is she's fast, and when I'm using a gun, fuck. Like the Magnum. There we go. Now I want the Magnum. She's scuttling. Oh, Marguerite. Run. So, ideally what you want her to do is fall over. You want her to fall down. Oh, I fell. That's a problem. It's not the end of the world. I just run back up the stairs. But, you want her to fall down, because if she falls down, you could shoot her nether regions more easily. I think she has to fall down 3 times. Where'd she go? See, this is the other thing with this fight, is like, it's random, so she will just she'll decide when she wants to show up and fight. I think she's behind me again. Where are you? It's annoying. Annoying. Marguerite's not playing very well today. This is the only fight I can think of that's like super random in the whole game, because everybody else just comes running at you. Come on, Marguerite. There's a delay with her. I didn't notice there's like a delay with the Magnum. That's not very helpful. Get out of my face! Oh, okay. That was a wasted shot. Yeah, the bug friends are back. I might use a health now, actually. Oh, hey, Marguerite. Get down. She glitched there. That's fine. Ow, ow. Oh, God, she's so annoying. She's so annoying. Hate Marguerite. All damage is good damage against Marguerite, though, so we're doing okay. Hey, Marguerite. I only have 3 shots left in the Magnum. So we're going to switch to the shotgun, which is a very good... The broken shotgun is a super powerful weapon. It's really good to have that fucking thing. Get out of here. It's a really super powerful weapon. So it's good to have against Marguerite. But she's not playing very nice. Which is... unfortunate. Come on.
Here I come.
Oh yeah? Oh, there. Whoa. Hey, Marguerite. You only get 2 shots with the shotgun though, which is annoying. There. So this is what you want, ideally. Her to fall over. There she goes. There you go. She falls. Oh! Flailing. She's kind of glitchy too. Which doesn't help. I think that's my last health item. That's fine. We're fine. She only needs a couple more hits. I think she's done. This is the worst part of the run. So as long as we get past this, fine. We're golden. The thing that sucks is dying here, like, I have to redo the save and then redo this fight, which is annoying as fuck. So, ideally, she dies here in the next little bit. She's roaming around. Bug. Get out of here, bug! Marguerite is so annoying. Oh, there she is. Oh, is that it? And then that's it? Oh, yeah. Get out of here, Marguerite. All right, let's get the fuck out of here. All right. Oh, I need her lantern. Her lantern spawns where her body dies. Oh, that was unfortunate time loss. Okay. So where Marguerite dies, her lantern drops. So I need the lantern. Okay. So that wasn't too bad. I found that the shotgun was way more effective than the handgun, which is interesting. All right, so now we need to get 2 key cards, and then we're on to Lucas, which will probably be the biggest. Well, I'm not gonna say that. There's a good time save there if I can kill this next boss pretty quickly. There's a pretty good time save there. So we're going back to the house, but it's actually faster to run along the thing, and I'm actually going to do a safety save because I'm a baby. I'm a baby. All right, Marguerite is done. I'm done with Marguerite. So we're done with the first big hurdle of this run was Marguerite. I'm also going to check the time, which doesn't count against me, which is nice. So let's check the time. An hour 10, not bad. But most speedrunners would be pretty much done with the game at this point. Okay, I think we're good on items, so let's go. So we're at an hour 10. We still got 3-some-odd hours to go before the achievement. But honestly, we'll probably be coming in at around 3 hours and change at the end of this. Because the next couple sections alone will probably take a couple hours. Because there's some... Excuse me. There's some unskippable stuff coming up that I can't, you know... I have no control over the time of that, so... Here... The piano's playing by itself. That's not creepy. And then we're gonna hang this lantern and be on our merry way. There you go. Alright.
Yes.
There is... nothing of importance to grab in here, I don't think. Like, item-wise. Well, it doesn't matter. This is on easy. There'll be items fucking everywhere. So the next thing we need to do is... Wow, I had the brightness on normal when I first played this. I didn't see any of this shit. Like, all this fungi. Oh, there's also going to be molded when I'm running out of this room. So hopefully that goes well. I'm stopped. I can't move until she says stay away. Okay, thanks. And now I can move. So there's going to be a little hidey hole here. There we go. And there's the arm I need. So again, I can't control how fast I take the arm. But running out of this room, there's going to be molded. I'm going to try and run past all the molded. Then we're going to save one more time at the trailer because we got to talk to... we got to talk to Zoe once on the way out. And then we need to do another phone call in the trailer. And then, hey, Evelyn. We need to get 2 key cards, go to the testing... Get the fuck out of my... He's going to be on... He was in my way. Unfortunately, I had to waste some shotgun ammo on him. Another reason why I keep the brightness up, so I can see what the fuck's going on. It's helpful to kind of, like, look at the floor. So you kind of look where you're running. Okay, good. So we are going to run to the trailer real quick. Hopefully the next... Oh, yeah, Zoe. The next big thing we need to do is collect ammo while we're in Lucas's testing facility.
Did you find it?
I got it. Are we really going to be able to make serum with this thing?
It'll be fine.
I'm really nervous about the ship, everybody. The ship is,
together. I'll be waiting for you.
Terrifying, because it's, you know, it's easy to get lost in that ship, especially if you don't know which way you're going. So hopefully the ship doesn't cost us like an hour, or not an hour. Because at this point, when it gets close to the end, when I'm in the 3-hour mark... Then it's all about, you know, it's all about timing at that point. So I'm going to check it. I'm not going to check the time again until we get to the ship. Jack 3 is when I'll check the time. Like I said, if it's over 3 hours when we get to Jack 3, I don't know. It might be a little too close. I'm hoping for 2.5 hours when we get to Jack 3. Okay, so I'm going to save real quick. Oh, I have to do the phone call first. Is this Zoe, I wonder? Pray tell?
Where the hell are you?
Yeah, Zoe, what happened? Where are you?
You only need the head, and you've got it.
Where is it?
This is going to help me and me, right?
Hey, buddy.
That's not Zoe.
I decided that Zoe...
Surprise!
She and Mia are here with me. And they're keeping...
Oh, what a jerk. Lucas is a jerk.
Just let them both go. What do you
big old jerk.
No,
I don't like Lucas.
Family business, Ethan, and not your concern, understand? Now, if you want the head, feel free to come by any time.
Oh, and there's also, I forgot, I have to do the, I have to go underground again. This is the bullshit revisit. For literally no reason. It's just a trigger.
What activity?
It's just a trigger to activate more enemies. It's really dumb. Come on. So, yes, I have to go back down into that basement area. Because I have to go back to where that cop was in the dissection room. Again, no reason other than to advance the story. So let's look in the fridge. Open. Oh my god! And then look at this. The pig is waiting in the same room. Okay. So let's save real quick. All right, saving because I'm a weenie. Okay, here we go. So we gotta go back into the house. We need two key cards, a blue and a red. I know where they are, but I need the snake key in order to get access both areas. And the snake key is downstairs. I have plenty of space. All right, here we go. I'm not gonna save on this because I just saved, so if the time loss would be insignificant. So I need to go back to the dissection room where I fought Papa Jack. Hopefully there's no molded down here giving me trouble, because that cost me a lot of time earlier. Here we go. There is no shortcut back to the dissection room. I have to take the long way around. Which is annoying. Oh, hey, Grandma. Grandma was just left down here by Jack. Like a asshole. Okay. Don't worry about that. Why? Jerk. I forgot about that. Whatever. It's fine. Everything's fine. Okay. So, I need the snake key. No, that one. Alright. Need the snake key. So I can get to the bedroom, which I'll do first, and then the attic.
Ew.
Yeah, it's gross. All right, so now there's gonna be some new molded for me to fight everywhere. Again, I'm trying to avoid them. Oh, he might move. There's one downstairs that could be a problem if I don't do this fast enough. Okay, go. Okay. Shotgun shells, yes, thank you. All right, so basically what happens is, I don't need that kind of fluid. Basically what happens is, Lucas, once you pick up the snake key, it activates a shit ton of new molded throughout the area. Thankfully on easy mode, there isn't that many and they die super fast, especially if you have the powerful weapons I have. I have the broken shotgun and I have the, Magnum. So I am going to save right now that I have the snake key, because why not? There you go. All right. So now we're going to be heading to the master bedroom first, because I believe that's faster than doing the, attic first. So we're going to be doing that. So we're going to ignore the molded. They're slow. So it's bad. As long as I menu pretty quick over here. Go. And the molded don't like doors. So you shut? Okay. I'm going in this room just because there are some extra things in here that I could use, like some more ammo and stuff. I'm doing super safe strategies here. Fuck, I thought there was more stuff in here. Oh, there's a backpack, so that's important. Professional speedrunners of this game, like legit people who play this, they will completely ignore all this stuff. They would not bother with any of these, but I'm a little low on items. I'm a little lower than I would like to be on some items, so I'm just taking the time to look around real quick. How much handgun ammo do I have? All right, I'll switch back to the Magnum for a little bit. So, pro tip. All the clocks are set to 10:15 in the house. That's what this puzzle is. Oh, I'm so stupid. Oh my god. Time loss is so great. I was looking at the big hand, like, oh, I'm stupid. It's fine. I'll add that as a highlight later. Can't read clocks like a dummy. I was like, wait a minute, what's going on? All right, here we go. So basically, the whole point of coming down here is to get the blue key card. But guess where it spits me out? It spits me out back in the basement again. So it's easier just to do the revisit of the basement first and then be on our merry way. I believe a molded pops up. But again, we're ignoring the molded. We don't care about the molded. Right. And then we're going to head to the attic. That's unfortunate. Why did I reload? Get on my face. Oh, shit. That's all right. That's all right. We're fine. We're fine. So now we're going up to the attic. Thankfully, you can sprint and reload. Did you know you could do that? You can do that. You can sprint and reload like a motherfucker. All right. We're going up to the attic to get the other... Yes, babe.
How is it tied to the other game?
It takes place a few...
Does it say that later? Later,
there's a reference to the other games.
Oh.
Jerry?
Because you're just like... You're not in like a lab or anything. You're just in the house.
Right. All right. That was unfortunate. Another time loss, which sucks pretty bad, but whatever. We'll live with it. We'll live with it and carry on. Snakey. Again, I'm going to be looking around this room for items because I'm a wuss and I need items. Handgun ammo especially is super important because of the Magnum. But as we're witnessing, the Magnum isn't that great. The Magnum is adequate at best. I'm not noticing. Actually, the shotgun is doing way more damage than the handgun. Anyway, you would find the happy birthday tape in here, which is actually super important if you're trying to play the game legit with trying to finish Lucas's area super fast. There we go. See, if you get it close, it will count. And it'll be like, whatever. Oh, plus, who built all this shit? Like Ethan said earlier. Who builds these weird shadow puzzles? Very odd. I can't jump down. I have to go down the normal way, which sucks. All right. So we got the two key cards. I'm actually going to go and make some first aid real quick in the trailer. But we're done with the house. We are, until later on in the game, much later, we are done with the house. We just need to answer this phone. It's basically Lucas saying, hey, remember those two key cards? Well, you got both of them, so come on in. It's like, well, no shit. I was heading there anyway. There's some questionable things. Now, this section is, again, where it's a little slower paced. From now until the rest of the game, it's like there's a lot of cutscenes you can't skip. And, you know, it's a little tricky. Not until the finale is where you really can start saving time. I lost some time on Marguerite. Oh, there's going to be jumpy dudes out here, which I'm trying to avoid. They're behind me. Oh, there's one. We're going to avoid those guys and come inside real quick. We're going to save, and then I think I'm going to make some chem stuff. I'm going to make some first aid stuff because I have 4. Oh, yeah. I put away 2 chem fluid because I'm fucking smart. Okay. So we're going to make 2... first aids. What else we got here? We're not going to need, I believe, we're not going to need the croaky anymore. We're done with that. No more croaky. We have 1 first aid med. We have, why do we have, oh, because 3 is the most. Okay, I'm done with the snake key as well. I don't need the arm right now because that will come later. And I think that's it. Okay, I'll save again, actually, just to, we should be at 1 hour and 30 minutes, 1 hour 40. I'm going to check real quick because I'm scared. 1 hour 25. Good. Underestimate. Okay. Run past these dudes. I don't know if you can. I may have to deal with them. Where's the other one? Oh, it's behind me. Oh. Wait, is he dead? Wow. On normal. These things are fucking pushovers. Or easy. On easy. They are pretty tricky on hard, actually. So that is pretty cool. All right, we're coming up to a bathroom break / food break. If you want, there's an unskippable piece of video here. So if you need to go to the bathroom or grab some food or want to stop watching, I hope you're enjoying yourselves. I just lost a few viewers, but I hope you're enjoying yourselves. We're underestimate, which is nice. I would like to be done with Lucas, like this whole section, in about 2 hours. So we're about 30 minutes left on that. There's a boss fight coming up that could cost us some time. But hopefully not too much. Do we want a story check real quick? Should we bother doing a story check? So basically at this point, Lucas, this fine fellow, has kidnapped Mia and Zoe. He has that thing which we need to create a cure for either Zia, Zoe or Mia. I'm sorry, I'm a barfy mess. Yeah, I did that. I don't care. I had to burf. Burf. You see, so Lucas is kind of like, he likes playing games. He likes saw-like puzzles. And there's booby traps all around the place. So we got to avoid those. But honestly, it's easier just to shoot them. But again, I'm trying to conserve ammo for the next boss fight coming up. Everyone's so rude. Everyone curses in this game so terribly and so rude. So basically we have to run through Lucas's section. Again, there's a stupid thing where the passcode is always the same, 1408 for the door, but you can't do it. You can't do it until you hit a flag, which I'm calling triggers in the game. You have to hit a certain flag in order to progress to the next section. It's really annoying. It would save a lot of time and skip a whole boss fight if you could just hit 1408 on the panel when you first get there, but you can't do it. It won't let you. At least as far as I know, you can. I'm going to try it. But, because I assumed it was just, it was random numbers each time, but that's not the case at all. Okay, so now we're entering Lucas's hellhole, as I call it. There's going to be booby traps everywhere. So I'm actually going to also take this moment to scavenge for more items. There's ones that hang from the ceiling. Those are the ones that I'm most concerned with. The second repair kit, if you're wondering, if you want the other handgun, is up there on the other side of this room. Anyway. So there is a... Oh, right here. I'm sorry. It's right here. If you want the gun repair kit. There's one that's eye level. I have to shoot these, unfortunately. Okay. Just to get those out of the way. All right. I don't want to waste the bullets, but we should be collecting a shit ton of bullets in this section, so we should be good. That is fake. Yep. Also, another thing Lucas likes to do is put fake boxes everywhere. I forget if that's fake or not. Yeah, it is. Okay. Ah, you're so funny, Lucas. Okay. So this is the door. Oh, shit. I didn't notice that until I ran into it. Oops. Oopsie poopsie. I'll be healing before I get to the boss. Oh, what is that? Okay. So we're going to try something here. So the code for this door is always 1408. But I think if I put it in, it just won't work. Again, this is rail shooter type stuff. It's a cutscene trigger to get you to the next section. So I'm just gonna do the actual 1408. Oh, there we go. So basically, I gotta wait for this stupid thing to fall. Actually, I might as well take that out. And then I need this thing to fall, and then there's gonna be a hidden door that's gonna open. Okay, come on. Come on, glitching. Again, there are items that I would like. No, that's chemical. Is there? I'm playing it a little safer than I probably need to. I'm probably wasting more ammo killing the crates than actually gaining. But, oh, see, but there you go. I got some handgun ammo right there. Oh, okay. My fiance's interrupting me. What's up?
Season 2 photo was released. And they're all wearing Ghostbuster outfits.
Of course they are. Well, that's when Ghostbusters came out around that time.
Carry on.
Whoa! Whoa! Ah! Shit! Oh, this is a problem. This is a problem. This is a problem. Did it kill him? It did. Oh, Jesus. That could have been bad. No, there was an enemy that came from behind me. In my other playthroughs, he didn't... oh, the fucking anti-coin, really? In my other playthrough, oh, sweet, some steroids. So I will take that, because why not? Steroids increase your max health permanently. So it was totally worth it coming in here, but that guy's a dickbag for interrupting me. Okay, so we're going to try and get past some enemies here. with some speedy quickness. Yeah, we're good. Excuse me, there's a safe room right here. And we're gonna save real quick. So we're coming up on the second boss fight, or the next boss fight, because we've had quite a few boss fights already. Surprisingly, we've had quite a few boss fights in this game already. Shotgun shell is important. And I think that's it. That's all we need. Let's make sure. Yeah. Okay. We're gonna be using the Magnum for a majority of this fight. So the next fight's gonna be through that door. We're jumping down here. Lucas has another little thing he wants us to partake in. These enemies suck. Super bad. Which ones are fake? That one's fake. Okay, cool. Handgun ammo. That's all I want. Okay. So far, the return on investment is pretty good. How many health things do I have? Oh, I have plenty of health. Okay, so this next fight should go okay, actually. Shotgun? Handgun? Handgun. Alright. I always reload if I waste it on a bullet. Alright, so that's going to blow up. I don't need to look at that. Alright, so our enemy is going to be coming out of here. He's going to spit some poopy at us at the beginning of the fight. We don't want to be standing there when he spits the poopy. But no, I think he doesn't spit it until... I can do something else. Oh, shit. Alright, I didn't optimize that as well as I could have. But not the enemy.
Fuck you too!
Accuracy is more important than being. Stand behind a pillar. The thing about the Magnum is that it's extremely powerful. Fall down. Shit, I fucked that up.
I really don't know what to say about that.
There we go. Alright, fight could have gone a lot worse, actually. So it wasn't bad. I had to concentrate there for a second. I'll have to fight those things two more times. Actually, I could avoid two of them. I can just avoid fighting them. But the final fight with them is a little tricky. Trying to get away. I have to stun them. Either with a sticky bomb. I can throw a sticky bomb and stun them. Or the rocket launcher and Nero rounds. Which I might just keep some chem fluid to make those. But overall, not terrible. Yeah, why not? Could have gone a lot worse. Okay, so the code, guess what? Oh, 1146. It did change. Look at that. 1146. I thought it always stayed the same. The last few playthroughs I saw, it was 1408, but it's 1146. Thank you, Sarah. 1146. Okay, so before I can start... Oh, actually, I can put the code in first, and then he's going to tell me to put all my shit away. 1146. Boop. Okay. So he's going to tell me to put all my gear away, which is fine with me because I don't need it for this next section. So the next thing is a puzzle that Lucas wants us to solve. I can make another chem. Okay. There's another thing that Lucas wants us to solve. So I can't do anything until... I'll just stand right here so I can get the candle. All right, cool. It's another thing Lucas wants us to solve. I think so. Okay, so there's that. So we just need to come over here. I gotta wait for him to finish talking. Again, more rail stuff. So basically, if you watch the Happy Birthday tape before coming in here, you'll know what to do. But if you don't, you have to do this twice because the solution will kill you. But if you already know the solution before doing it, you'll be able to skip this whole section and save so much time. So we need this pilot light lit. There we go.
Hello.
We'll get this candle. My fiance is going to be talking on the phone over there, so apologies. Burn this rope. All right, so we're going to run. Now, the answer to this always is loser.
Jesse.
Big pro tip. The answer to this is loser. So,
E7E.
R. There we go. And there you go. And then you got this thing and Jimmy Jams. So now we got to turn off the water and place the cake down. And also, one thing I'm going to do to save a little time. We're going to save a little time by taking this board off the wall because Lucas is going to do something really, really unsportsman. Unsporting, I should say. So let's pop this on there. Turn the water off.
Yeah, it was raining.
We're about to get to Jack 3, which is making me nervous. And then we're going to go light the candle again and then put it on the cake. And we're good. And we're done with Lucas's section. We're coming up to the part of the game where it makes me nervous on time. All right. There we go. Happy birthday to me. Okay. Oh, my God. It exploded. All right. So he's going to throw a bomb in here. Need to pick up the bomb, put it in here. Back up a little bit. I'm gonna block. Oh, I'm so scared of the explosion. Oh, my face. How dare you? Is it gonna blow up? I did it so early that the bomb still needs to tick down. Oh, there it goes. All right, here we go. Bye, Lucas. Alright, so we're gonna grab this. So we got the head and the arm, and now it's coming up to the part that I'm one of the first parts that I am most not looking forward to doing is Jack 3.
We're just beyond the pier.
Okay. I don't know if I needed to do that. I may have been able to skip that, but I just did it for the sake of doing it.
Is that your car?
Fuck do you want?
I know, I heard like a
dead.
Guess that's not in the cards.
I may have not needed to do this.
Oh.
Which
unless you have any more surprises up your sleeve, I suggest you
fuck, I don't know if I needed to do this.
That would be telling Ethan.
Cuz gives me 3 or 4 minutes or 2 or 3 minutes. Okay. Deck. All right. Let's save right quick. Good, good. And now we're coming to Jack 3, and there's also a bunch of molded we need to get by, which, not fun. So, hold on, I need to scoot forward here. I need the arm. I need the Alberts. Sure. And handgun ammo. I'm actually going to take chem fluid so that I can make another health.
Oh,
okay,
man,
here we go. Here we go. So I need to crank 2 things in this area.
Yeah, I had my phone like off to the side. I felt like something vibrated.
Sorry again, my fiance's on the phone with her mother.
I looked and it was like right.
Here we go. Coming to the second half of the game, like the end game areas. There's 2 end game areas after this. There's a ship and there's the mine. The ship is more dangerous for time loss than anything else. So
cool.
I could go in there to grab some stuff, but I don't necessarily need to. So, I'm going to use the shotgun for this section. Because I get more than 2 shots off, but it is super, super powerful. So this raises that bridge over there. I need to get over there into that door. I might be able to run past most of this molded, but there's some that jump in my way, like that asshole. There we go. I'm gonna reload while we're running.
Okay.
There's some more over there. They're coming, but I'm gonna try and just ignore them.
Okay.
Save some time. Get out of my way. Oh, really? That's bullshit. Get out of my way, you dingus. Alright.
Yeah.
There's another one that pops up that I can get past. Alright, so we're gonna save again. Oh, can't, because the door's not closed. Alright. I need. Now, this is a very important fight. This is the fight that will take the longest. I'm actually gonna make a separate save file here, too, because. I'm going to be coming back here after stream and do Zoe's ending just for the achievement, because why not? Alright. Are these Nero rounds? No, these are flame rounds. Those are not important to me. Shotgun shells, of course. Okay. So, this fight is Jack 3. It's probably the most annoying fight. Or no, the Marguerite's more annoying. This is one of the most annoying fights in the game. So, fun fact, you don't have to untie Mia at all. You could just help Zoe out, and it will start the next section. You don't need to have Mia.
He's coming. Daddy's coming.
Daddy's coming.
There's enough for two.
We gotta deal with Daddy. So we're gonna hang out with Zoe while she makes her crock pot recipe here. How are we doing on time? Doing okay, doing okay. Most speedrunners would be done with the game by now. but they have infinite ammo as well. Okay, just give me the thing. Okay. All right. One of those is mine. All right, so this is where hopefully we can get this fight done in under 20 minutes. And hopefully I don't die, because then I'll have to restart. So the whole thing with Jack 3 is you have to shoot. There's a bunch of eyeballs on his body that you need to shoot in order to get to the next phase. So I need to do my best. Yeah, see, already terrible. Fuck my. Yeah. All right. So. I don't know how many shots it's gonna take to take these eyes out. This fight is like. Annoying as hell.
This is getting old, Jack.
Might be worth doing the shotgun for this, actually. Ah, see, he moves so sporadic. It's hard to get a hit on him. Like I said, if I die, I'm gonna need. Fuck my ass! Come on. Ah. This fight is annoying. Alright, so that took like a shit ton of ammo to kill him to put that eye out. So let's try the. Oh, shotgun's one hit. Yeah, this is much better. Yes, this is much better. Alright. I'm gonna get close here. Whoop. Okay, that's a trigger thing. That's gonna happen no matter what. I think there's one on the top of his back. The other thing is keeping track of which eyes you've hit, so you're not, still a problem. I need to get his front eye. You want to try and keep his front eye, it's too far away. That's the eye that's a big problem, is the one in the underbelly.
Oh.
See, it's like, it's so tricky to get these eyes. Ah, you dick bag. See, it's just like, his tail will hit you too, which is annoying. What eyes am I doing? I need to do the under eyes, so I need to get him to climb up. Which is unfortunate. This is not the position I wanted to be in. I don't know if going up top will make him climb up anytime soon, but, oh no, I think there's an eye over here. Did I get this eye on his arm? Nope. Oh, there we go. There's another eye right there. See, look at this shit. Like, okay, so the eye and his underbelly is the only eye that I need to deal with, and the problem is I need him to go up top, so I'm actually gonna see if I can go up. Go up. Go up. Go up. Alright, so. What's it? I hit it. He's gonna be going over here. No! That's unfortunate. This is not going well. Because if that eye is the worst one to have be the last one, because it's kind of random when he decides he wants to go back up. Fuck. What? Well, shut up, Jack. I don't know if going up will make him. I think he's just listening to me right now.
Hey, good job.
I need him to go up. I need him to go up. I could try going up and see if. I think he's gonna go up now. No? Are you going up? Maybe if I can get him near one of these holes, he'll go up.
Right. Oh,
jerk. Go up. There he goes. Okay. I just need to. Oh my god! See how much time you lose? Nope. There we go. Oh my god. That took much longer than it should have. So I need to be near here? I forget where I need to be. He's gonna start digging. I think I need to. Okay, he pulls me under. Zoe's gonna be like, so I need to shoot. Oh, fuck off. Oops, that was shitty. Jack is very rude. I need to be by this door, so. There we go. Not bad, not bad. I need to be by this door for Zoe. Okay, that was Jack 3. He's really annoying.
I've seen everything.
Okay, come on. Come on. Whoops. Come on, Zoe.
Ethan, this way.
I'm right here. Okay. So they're going to tell me, use the serum on him.
Use the serum on him.
Okay.
You want me to cure him?
Okay, there we go. And Jack's like, ooh, yeah, ooh, that's nice. That's real nice. All right, so the biggest instance, the last bit of RNG, really. Oh, it's spoopy! Well, in VR, whatever.
Are you all right?
Come on, let's go. That's the last bit of RNG for the boss.
Right.
Only got one left. Oh no, let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Alright. So now I gotta choose Zoe or Mia. For sake of speed, we're choosing Mia. Because there's a second fight you have to do with Mia later on. And that takes up like, you know, 3-4 minutes. So we don't want that. So we're gonna be saving our wife. A wonderful, crazy, possessed wife, Mia. Cure Mia. There we go. We want to make sure we cure Mia. So now, again, we're entering another section where we can't control anything.
Go. Both of you just
now I'm really nervous.
Come with us.
About the boat section.
Sure, there's someone who can help. This is not.
The ship section is the hardest to navigate in the game. I feel like the house, the Baker house, makes sense. It's really well designed. The ship is a little chaotic. I just have to remember the phases, what I need to do. There's also going to be a little surprise coming here in a little bit. Again, another break, another bathroom break or whatever, because I am just on a rail shooter at this point and I cannot move. So we're at about 2 hours, which is where I was hoping we would be finished with Jack 3. So it's good. We still got 2 hours to go in about an hour and a half, I feel like, of gameplay. So I think we're on track here for the 4-hour estimate. The only thing that could really trip us up right now is the ship, the confusion of the ship, and also the loading time. I don't know if it counts it, but the loading time going into Mia's flashback, because it's the only VHS we have to watch. But like I said, here's hoping this next section goes well, because basically what I need to do in the first half is get a fuse.
We need to talk.
Excuse me. Open a door. Chase Evelyn around the thing. Watch the VHS tape. Once I'm in the VHS tape, find the first thing. Go down to S2.
I honestly don't.
Right. Like, if the
or no, go up to floor 3. And then, oh my God, sorry. Then go up to floor 3.
Is that the boat?
Chase Evelyn. Go back down to S2. It's like a whole runaround. Like the Mia's flashback is literally just exposition, exposition. In the second half of Mia's, I will actually be going to the safe room, after I get the fuse, or as I get the fuse, because A, I'm gonna do a safety save in case I lose time, and B, I'll get my Magnum back, which again, I won't even bother picking up the machine gun in the second half of Mia's playthrough because it's completely useless. I don't need it at all if I have the machine gun and eventually the shotgun, which I will be getting later once I take control of Ethan again. Spoilers.
Yeah,
well, as you're about to see, I think we have a change of protagonist here. Which is funny because if you save Zoe, if you make the choice to save Zoe, you end up playing as Mia anyway. It literally makes no difference. So I don't know why that was even given as a choice. So this section is really just rail shooter. This is just you wandering around until you get to Evelyn.
Like, why can't she just go on?
But there is one section you do get to play. Again, sorry, my fiance's on the phone. There is one section you... Oh, there's Ethan. I almost ran right by him. Ethan's not doing pretty well if he's tucked by his codex. I always got sucked up by some goopy. So there goes Ethan. Have a nice night, Ethan. All right. Where am I going? Oh yeah. So basically, I need to. Come on. I need to. There's only one section where there are enemies, and I have to kind of pay attention, but. Thankfully there's a save room and a box in there which will have my Magnum and everything in it. It's not supposed to, but because this is, I think it will have the Magnum because this is a new game. I think every item box has the Magnum in it. I don't have any items right now. This first half is literally just story. It's just you're wandering around the ship. Oh, it's spoopy, and then story happens. Ignoring it, I'm just running. Run in. There's technically only one boss left, because there's a couple of refights with the fat puking boss, but you can skip those. There's one dangerous one at the end of the mine section that I may or may not be able to skip, but I'm going to try to skip it the best of my ability, because that will cost me some time if I screw that up. But there's a save room not far behind in case I do screw it up. All right, so again, there's going to be a flashback here, but I need to go in this door anyway, so I'm just going to be hanging out until this flashback is over. In my original playthrough, I didn't get to the ship until about 7 hours in, so we're about almost 2 hours. Actually, let's check the stats right now. We are at 155. We're under fucking 2 hours, and in my original playthrough, it was... It's about 7 hours when I got here. So it really goes to show like how much of this game is exploration, how much of it is item collecting and item management. Again, I played this on normal the first time. This is a completely different playthrough on normal. Enemies are a lot more challenging. The bosses are a lot harder. It's still not that hard, but it's still not as like a breeze as this. So... I believe we are... Are we in it yet? We're not there yet. But that's why if you're trying to do a speedrun or trying to do this estimate, it's easier to do it on easy because everything is so much easier to deal with.
That you're supposed to do that, right? So, you're supposed to make visuals.
Here we go. Again, another story thing I can't skip. A lot of this and... Oh, there's Evelyn. Is she really there? Question mark. Is she like legit? I'm spoiling this. So my buddy Mike, if you're watching and you're playing this game, and my buddy Max, if they're listening, I'm spoiling the shit out of this. So sorry, but I did warn everyone starting that this was a spoiler. I mean, I'm playing the whole fucking game in under 4 hours. I mean, come on now. We are underestimate, and I'm loving it. I thought that we'd be over 2 hours at this point. Nope, we are not even at 2 hours yet. So we're about close. So we're just a lot of again. A lot of this is just blowing through. A lot of this is just blowing through. Okay, there's Evelyn. Evelyn has a very. I'm sorry. My fiance's on the phone. Okay, so now we're at the part where we're actually playing. So there's enemies here and everything. But before we do anything, I'm actually going to try and get in this room without this guy hitting me so I can save. Fuck off. Fuck off. I failed miserably. Uh-huh. Okay. We're going to save over the second one. Okay. Yeah. So there's a box in here, I think. I'm not even going to get the gun because it's fucking pointless. Is there no box in here? There is no box. Okay. I'm not getting the gun because it's pointless. We're gonna go this way. So we're gonna go around. I'm actually losing time a little. All right, we're going the other way. Fuck. I was hoping not to pick up any health items because I may have to do the tricky strategy. There's a health item in there. Actually, I should have went and grabbed. All right, I'm doing the tricky.
It's hard.
I'm doing the tricky strategy. I may take a hit here. Ah, fuck. Oh my god. Yeah. It's fine. Everything's fine. Everything's fine. Don't worry. So I did the tricky strategy, but we should be good. We should be good. So I just need to put...
Yeah.
Okay, there we go. Alright, tricky section. Whew, done. So now the next bit that we need to deal with is Evelyn... showing us a flashback via remembering the things that she seems to have amnesia. Seems to have amnesia about. Yes, it is. Okay. So again, rail shooter. We're just walking. And here we go. So there's going to be a huge... Okay, bullshit, 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 bullshit.
What?
There you go. Bullshit, 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 bullshit. There you go. All right. So longest break of the game is this loading sequence. Even though it is... fucking mandatory. Look how long this takes. On PC, it would have, boom, been loaded.
That's good.
But, Jesus. It is a long loading screen.
Like, I don't like that I'm in a
I don't see anyone new in the chat, so... Oh, here we go. That was faster than I thought. Okay. We're back. And we're playing the feud. Okay. So this section, the best to optimize... I'm gonna keep the machine gun again for safety since I don't get a shotgun. But to optimize movement, it's really just remembering where I need to go in the ship because this ship is a labyrinth. And if I get too sidetracked, it will cost me a lot of time. So, here we go. We're making good time. We're about 2 hours in now. 2 hours, 1 minute, 2 hours. And change. Come on, let me go. So what's happening in the story is Mia's having a flashback to her memories that she had amnesia about, and this shows what happened, how the tanker ended up where it did. I'm actually coming here so I can get my I'll keep it, and then I'm taking these as well because if I take some hits all right. There's some machine gun ammo. No, I didn't want that. Okay, so there's no save point in here, so we're just gonna get going. All right, here we go. So I believe the first place I need to go.
When I talked to her, she said that they were fine, that they were settling in.
All right, so this is the first place I need to go. This saves some time going this way. I'm gonna pick up as much ammo as possible. That's the other thing is that her little codex is gonna pop up all the time, basically telling me where Evelyn is. And
I have to reset.
All right, I have to reset. Gotta call Alan, and then we're gonna get out of here.
She's vomiting.
So we need to go to the elevator now. So we're gonna run into molded as well. Again, we're gonna try to avoid most the molded, if we can. But I mean, again, my movement tech is pretty terrible. And also, I'm playing on a Jimmy Jam, not mouse. I'm playing on a controller, which makes things a little bit more difficult. Fuck it. I was gonna collect some items, but I'm gonna live on the edge. I'm living on the edge. So I believe that guy's gonna chase me. Nope, we're good. So I gotta hit the elevator button. I gotta wait for the elevator, like in real life. Making everybody dizzy. Is that chem fluid down there? I don't know. It's not. Okay. I believe there will be a molded that falls out of the ceiling. Get out of our face! Get out of the face! Okay, good. Level 2. Are you serious? Go! Go! Oh, I'm on level. I'm on level 2. Guess what, hey? Guess what, fuckos? We're on level 2. So we gotta get the thing. We gotta get the corrosive, which is basically like lockpicks, which you haven't seen this whole game. So there's a guy that's actually above us up here on the catwalk. Where is he? Oh, hey. We'll deal with this guy first. That might be on the read-through, actually, the replay. Okay, let's go. Let's go. There's a lot. Oh my god, there's a lot. So loud. Okay, get out of here.
Or it's like, turn on this weird side street here. And
I
then
shouldn't
turn
have
on
reloaded.
And you're like,
okay. Fuck off. Oh, sticky bombs. They're my favorite. Blah, blah, blah. All right. So there's going to be more.
Because Waze is.
Is this a big boy?
Yeah, because Waze is crowdsourced.
No.
So maps are edited.
I don't know if he's dead.
Users.
We'll find out.
So if there's a user.
Sarah's talking about Waze. Basically, this section is just running from point A to point B and then point B to C again. Like, that's really it. Like, there's not much movement tech or anything too crazy. The replay of this later is much more difficult. So Evelyn's in there. But we need corrosive stuff, which is in here. I'm actually gonna get that chem fluid, because why not? We're gonna open this up. I have sticky bombs, which is so helpful for some bosses later on. We're only gonna be using, I think, one corrosive, maybe two, because we don't need it for a lot of things. So we come over here.
How rude.
Use the corrosion. And then we gotta go back up. It's so stupid. We gotta go back up. So Evelyn basically is like, we gotta do ring around the rosy here.
No, Evie, I'm not mad.
So basically, we run around a circle. I can't run faster than this, which is fun. And then she wants to be my mommy. She wants me to be her mommy.
Just come back with me.
Okay. Now things get fucking crazy because Evelyn's gone crazy. There's more molded, which again, they're not that big of a deal with the machine gun on easy. And we need to get upstairs. I can't open this door until I'm done talking to Alan. There we go. Alright. Moving. I think a proper speed run of this is not possible unless you're on PC. Just due to... just because of the loading time. The loading times are a huge deal here, and they do cost a lot of time. I don't need that corrosive door. That's just items. We are good. All right. Move, 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 move. Oh, get out of my face. Get out of my face. Nope. Oh, pissed ass. That's fine. That's fine.
Okay.
I have... Oh, okay. We're going to use some stick. Fuck off. Sticky bombs don't hurt me. You dead? Okay. Go.
Okay.
And now we're going to the third floor. Third floor, please. Menswear. the replay of this section will be much more difficult. Much more difficult.
Emergency safety lockdown system.
So we're gonna open the elevator. The replay of this, because you have to go to two separate areas and it's a pain in the ass.
What's the point?
Okay, so I believe, if I remember correctly, this is where things get a little tricky.
Damn it.
Gone. Oh shit! I could have saved time by ignoring this. Actually, I should have went the other way. Balls. Okay. Basically, Alan's missing.
Where the hell are you?
I should have went that way instead of the other way. I did that in my first playthrough as well. Yeah. There's gonna be more molded.
Okay. I have to
get past.
Oh.
Basically, I just need to get to the stairs. Is where I'm heading next. Mm-hmm. Wait. Oh, that's right. That's right. Up here.
So all right.
Not bad. I only fucked up a little bit. Whoop. So I believe that's the stairs. All right. I'm going up to the third floor to deal with Evelyn. Or to try and contact Evelyn. Oh, Jesus. Wait, did I go the wrong way?
Okay.
Am I missing something?
Out.
What? Shouldn't this be open? What am I, insane? Am I missing something? If the door is still closed, I am flummoxed as to why the door is still closed. What the fuck?
If you go somewhere that cold.
I'm supposed to come here. Are you kidding me? Like.
No, I need to go. I need, especially since.
So lost for where?
Huge houses over there.
Okay.
Huge, like,
I'm gonna have to pause here and look up what exactly is happening, because I'm lost for what I'm supposed to be doing. So yeah, this door is supposed to be open, but it's not. This door is not open. It's supposed to be open. So, all right. So, quitting the game, and then I'm going to have to redo that whole section again. I'm actually gonna watch a video real quick to ensure that I wasn't doing anything wrong. The fuck! This door should be open. Like it should be open. There should be no reason that this door. Oh my god. Hey everybody, so it's not that door, it's this door. That's the door I'm supposed to go through. So I lost 3 minutes fucking around with that. So let's ignore that ever happened. Let's ignore that little situation happened and load the autosave. So let's ignore that happened. Like I said, this trip.
I'm moderating his chat, but nobody said anything for like an hour.
Oh, I don't care. I'll talk to no one. It's fine.
I think Mike's still watching.
Because Mike's a good friend. That's why.
Mike has two viewers, and I'm one of the viewers.
Yeah.
So I think it's just me and Mike.
Okay, so here's what happened. I don't know how much additional time I lost, but I don't think much from that autosave.
The way that it works is.
So yeah, I'm a fucking dingus and went the wrong way. So sorry, everybody. Shit, that is unfortunate. I don't think I need to even go to the Allen room now.
Mike said, I've been on the entire time.
Because Mike's a badass. If I had a... he would be a moderator in my chat for sure if I did this regularly, which I'm assuming nobody wants, but Mike and Sarah can be the mods. Oh my god, I can't believe I wasted so much time running around. I might make that into a nice... I won't get rid of him, he's my man forever. I might make a compilation of that and throw that on YouTube, because that's pretty... it's right here. Oh my god. That was a bummer. Sorry for wasting people's time. There's Alan. Okay. Oh my god, because they have so much time. Hi, Alan. Okay, now we're back. We're back on track. We're almost done with the tape.
Without the treatments, she's deteriorating.
Jesus Christ, that was a devastating loss of time.
Well, it's a good thing Marty died.
Well, it didn't lose me any time because the autosave, thankfully, kept my original time. Because when we were originally here, it was 2 hours, 14. It's not where I'm from. It's nothing like him. 2 hours, 14 minutes. So now we're about two hours, eight minutes. So we saved a few minutes coming back. Guys, it's just to show you, always be aware of your surroundings, because look everywhere, look all over the place. Just don't assume that one way is the only way to go, because gosh darn, that was unfortunate. All right, there's Evelyn. So again, more stuff we can't skip. 90% of this game is sequences like this that you just can't skip. You're just stuck. So we're almost done here. We got about an hour worth of game left. Between the ending of the ship, the replay of the ship and the finale, I think it was about an hour and a half left. So we're gonna skip making the video for Ethan. Yes. We're gonna avoid plot, because who cares? Oh, that's right, it just does it. So this is the end of the VHS tape. So we're making good time there. Oh, hey buddy, you need help? Oh, that's a shame. Okay. Together forever. Together forever. Oh, that's weird. I don't remember doing that. Going to a black screen, then a pre-rendered. I can't. This is all cutscene. So, long story short, this is how the Bakers became infected in the first place. This research ship. Mia is a part of a bio weapon company that makes bioweapons, and they had this research ship that crashed in the Louisiana Bayou. Evelyn and Mia were discovered by the Bakers, and then the Bakers took Evelyn in and tried to help her, but Evelyn, eventually, the little girl, infected the entire family, and then shenanigans ensued, as you see. So now we're done with that VHS memory, so now we're going to the next section of the game, which is the revisit of the ship, which is just more enemies, and we have to repair the elevator. Basically, we need the fuse from downstairs that we got last time, and then we need a cable that is in the medical area. So we'll be going upstairs, and we'll grab that. So I think I'm going to grab the fuse first, because that's faster. Go back up and then do the thing. There are some enemies, so thankfully I will get my magnum. I don't know if I get all my items back. I think I just get the magnum and the machine gun, because there's going to be some creepy crawlies that I need to deal with, which is a pain in the ass. So we should be coming in for a 3.5 hour landing here, roundabout, depending on some RNG with the last few bosses. We only have two more fights we really have to worry about. Evelyn and the two Blob Brothers. The Blob Brothers and the final fight with Evelyn are the two. But Evelyn isn't really that hard to deal with, especially on easy. I'm going to have my entire arsenal, so it should be okay. All right, so there's Evelyn. I remember everything. So as I finish up here, I'm probably not going to go for... I'll probably pick up a couple more items along the way, but I don't want to spend too much time going out of my way getting items. Shut up, Evelyn. You're rude. Okay, so now we're back. Let's save... thank God that's over with. And then I think is there a crate in here? I don't know where the nearest crate is. Okay, fuck it. Moving on. I didn't get the gun. Don't need it. What did I take? I don't even know what I picked up. The chem fluid. Perfect. Okay. because as of right now, I don't have a weapon. So I need to. I don't. I'll take some machine gun ammo. Again, I'm kind of going out of my way here to grab fucking chem fluid. Chem fluid sucks because it takes up.
Take that. I have
some
before.
Bullets. I begrudgingly make some bullets. All right. Moving on. Moving on. Okay. So there's going to be a jump scare coming up. So jump scare warning. And then this is the section where we need to. Now this is where things get a little tricky dicky. I need to remember where certain items are. I need the lug wrench to open the elevator. I think it's up here though. It has to be. And then. I'm going to ignore the machine gun, I think, because, again, I just really need the magnum, and I'm not going to be really fighting anything down here. Like, a couple things I'm going to be fighting, but a couple enemies, so.
Maybe it still works.
Just going to hit A a bunch until we get to Ethan. Come on now. That's the medical room where I need to go, and there's Ethan. Okay, so there's going to be a jump scare coming up. It's funny if you just... if you just stare at the screen long enough, there's a funny little glitch with Evelyn.
I saw it last time.
It didn't happen. Sometimes you can glitch her to go in the table, which is pretty funny.
Hallucinations. Where is she?
Yeah, so she's not real, as we discover. Evelyn is only a hallucination. She's real, but she's not like a problem. So this is the captain's quarters. I think, yeah, there it is. Okay, that was what I was worried about. I don't need the ship map. Okay, now we're on our way. Yeah.
Yeah, cold brew, coffee.
I'm gonna open this up. I think.
Where?
Drop down. I forget exactly where the save rooms are. I should have grabbed the map, maybe. And then we're gonna use the thing, Jimmy Jams, because. I'm actually, well, if I don't get the machine gun, then Ethan won't have it. But it's not that big of a deal. Go down. Go down. Go down. Go down. Okay. So we need bullshit. So let's go down to the... No. Go down first. Okay. We're gonna... Hey, buddy. We're gonna save again at a safety. We probably don't need to save, but again, if I die, because I just need to get the fuse run back to the thing. I could get the gun for the hell of it, but let's just try and do it without the gun. Let's just say we don't need it. Let's say we needed it and didn't need it, and there we go. So I just need... Nope. And the fuse. Done with part one. Now I need the medical cable. I took a hit. That's fine. Everything's fine. I don't have any healing items. It's pretty dangerous. Oh, wait. No. Okay. I need to go here. Go. Can you go up? Thank you. Survival knife. Huh. I didn't pick this up last time. That's interesting. There's a molded there. I'm gonna ignore him. Oh, there's a save box in here. Perfect. Save again, because I'm a wee baby. I didn't pick up the survival knife last time. That's interesting. I don't even know if it was there. I wasn't paying attention. So let's see. I need my Albert and my defense coin and secrets of defense. That's all I really need. All right. There's some handgun ammo. Perfect. Corrosive. I guess we'll take that in case. We're not going to really need it, though. So I need to get... to this medical Jimmy Jam. Actually, I need corrosive for that, I believe, to do the medical thing. Third floor. That's what I thought. So, that's just for you, Mike.
Oh, we have another viewer.
Oh, hey.
I don't know who it is.
I don't know either. Where on the third floor is this shit? Oh, back here? No, that's literally just... I love how I played through this game in its entirety And I can't. Oh, that corrosive door there. That's why I was saying earlier I needed to. Oh, hey, buddy. That's why I made a boo-boo. So, pro tip, guys. I hate using that term, but it's funny. It's locked on the other side. So, fun fact, if you run all the way around, you're going to get the thing. You need to start the elevator. There's going to be, supposedly, a boss fight in here, but you can skip the whole fight. You can ignore the whole fight and just run around the other side. It's pretty great. So, here we go. So, there he is. He's activated. He's coming. He's easy to get around, thankfully. There we go. Yeah. Gimme. He's behind me. Yep. So I need to go around this big man. Right. There we go. You don't have to worry about him. Don't have to worry about him at all. Because he's super slow. And he will not be causing us any issues. So that's it. That's all you really need to do for the ship. You just need to get two items. And you're done. So now we need to jump back in the elevator. Jump down here. And put this thing in there. Put the fuse in there. And there we go. Elevator is fully operational again. And then we want to go to S2. There we go. Alright. Now we're going to the end of the elevator. Or, sorry, end of the ship. Where we got to deal with... all right, we got to find Jack. So this is the set, or Ethan. This is where someone's gonna try and sneak behind me like a goopy fuck. There he is, like this bastard. So I'm gonna wait for him to drop down, and I'm gonna give him a little surprise. Where'd he go? Where'd he go? Come on, buddy, buggy boy. Come on. He's gonna get a nice little something, something. Hey. Oh, I missed. Reload, you dick. Wow. Oh, he's dead. That's why my shot went through him. Oopsie poopsie. There's another dude over here who I can't really avoid. Oh, God. Two shots take him out, but the death animation makes it. So, I have no health for this next part, which is a little scary because there's another fat boy I gotta deal with. So I actually do have to stop and collect items here. And some... I didn't even get the machine gun because I don't need it. Oh, shit. Oh, dicks. Okay. God, those things are the worst. On easy mode, they're much... simpler to deal with, but let's use some goop juice. Blah 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 blah. I'm stealing that from Markiplier. Sorry, but he's funny. He's funny. So machine gun ammo is kind of pointless right now, so I didn't pick it up. But I have sticky bombs, which will make the next couple encounters a joke. Handgun ammo. That's more important. The handgun ammo is way more important. Sticky bombs will make the next refight, like I said, pretty silly. I have four that should be. Oh wait, let me get rid of this goober first. There we go. Reload. I didn't get any of the stuff that makes me reload faster. Is that time? No. Hey, buddy. So he's on the ground. They could just do this. There we go. Joke. It was a joke. Like I said, it makes those fights a fucking joke. If you can, if you have sticky bombs. Alright, so we're gonna go deal with, let's go save Ethan. Now, if you had saved Zoe instead of saving, Mia, giving her the serum, in this section you would have had to fight Mia again because she still would have been infected. But she gets infected anyway, so I don't know what the point is. And then there's this weird thing. So I guess the way it works is if you are consumed by Evelyn's goopy stuff, you share this hive mind. So Jack and Zoe are there in the goop. And I'm having a little conversation with her. This is another part of the game where you can go take a break. Now, what did she stretch your legs? I'm gonna probably get up too.
She infected us with her gift.
Yeah, you can stick a crystal egg up your fahoo-hoo. That's what this game's really about. It's about trying to stop Gwyneth Paltrow from taking over the world and putting crystals in ladies' vahoo-hoos. So I'm gonna stand up, walk around a little bit. This sequence lasts for a bit. I'm actually probably gonna use the restroom real quick. Well, maybe not. That might be too much time.
Forces away into your mind, your soul. You can't fight back.
That might be a little too much to ask for going to the bathroom, but
and you can't resist the
Maybe. All right, I'll be right back. I'll be right back.
Oh, you're a different person after that. Just like Mia. So Mia sent me that message because of Evelyn. Listen. The girl just wants a family of her own. She's the key. All right? You find her, and you stop her. Ethan. Free my family. Please.
Stay away from him.
Why? He doesn't love you. I can make him love you.
Don't hurt him.
Silly, I told you I'm not gonna hurt him.
Don't you dare.
For what? You're not my mommy. Remember?
Okay, and we're back. I still have no control over the character, so this is the longest section of the game where you're not in control. Like I said, you can take a break. Mia. I was covered in goopy goop. Gwyneth Paltrow's goopy goop. Alright, so, like I said, normally if you save Zoe, you would have to fight Mia here. Which is very heartbreaking. You don't want to fight Mia again. So Mia sacrifices herself, but then she's infected anyway. So who gives a fuck? Even though I gave her the cure, so I guess you can get... Wow. I guess you can get reinfected. Oh, I think the litter's here, by the way.
No!
Yeah, that's what it said on my phone. We get kitty litter of our cats because it's important. Okay, here we go. Now we're done with the ship. Hooray, okay, huzzah.
What the fuck?
Hooray, huzzah.
Can you hear it delivered?
Well, on my phone it said it was delivered.
Can you hear it delivered?
Nope. Because I was wearing a headset. I'm done with the ship. There you go. All done. At about 2.5 hours. What's the estimate? 2:25. Nice. My estimate was 2.5 hours, so we're 5 minutes under estimate. Fantastic. So we're about to get in some water. I can't move any faster. No, there's about an hour left of game. I'm in literally the last section of the game. This is it. So I would say we'll probably be landing in at about 3.5 hours, that was my initial estimate. So that's 30 minutes of wiggle room. Like I said, any death or major fuck up, like before, I just revert back to an old save and save time. So here we go. We're going to one of the final save rooms. I think there's only 2 save rooms left. This one and one more. So yeah. Home stretch, people. Last hour.
It's open.
Oh, that's good.
Whatever.
We're gonna grab some stuff. Enhanced handgun ammo. Which makes the so I think we have to listen to that. Oh, look, we got the grenade launcher for some reason. That's my favorite part. It just gives you the grenade launcher. Not the type of rounds we want, but whatever. So I'm gonna get all my shit back. I don't need the knife. Shotgun. Don't need the crank. Take the coin. Secrets of the fence. First aid. Shotgun shells. Get some herbs. Handgun ammo. Handgun ammo. Machine. Oh no, I don't want that. I don't have the machine. Ignore that. Look how much handgun ammo I have. Yeah, we are A-okay for the rest of the game, I believe. Strong chem fluid. You know, machine gun ammo. We'll bring the remote bombs in case, and I'll bring the strong chem fluid. The reason I'm bringing the smart bombs and the grenade launcher is because there's a section coming up that I desperately need the grenade launcher. There's a section coming up where I have to fight two of those fat dudes who spit shit at. Actually, I'm gonna use a shot. Wait, where's my shotgun? And the thing is, they can be real. Actually, I can just make another. They can be real jerks. And the idea is, I want to stun them so that. Whoa, hey everybody. Normally, you can just run through here, but I'm going to take it safe because I got 30 minutes to spare. So. I'm just gonna take care of these guys. I think there's one more around the corner. Again, having the brightness all the way up helps. All right. Yeah, there's one. Get this going. Him done. All right. Get out of here. Oh, I have one shotgun left. That's actually fine. I wanted the shotgun for that sequence, in specifically that sequence. So we're heading down into the mine, which is the final section of the game, really. You go back to the house for a little bit, but this is the real final section of the game. Here we go. There's going to be a crawly dude, I think. Up here. And we're going to... Yeah, there he is. We're going to get some more items as well, which is nice because it is helpful for this final section. I'm not going to mess with any of these boxes because, whatever, we have plenty of health, plenty of ammo. I'm crawling here. Really? This is... How is that still alive? The Magnum's supposed to be, like, this all-powerful weapon, but, like, it really takes a lot to bring them down. The broken shotgun is the most powerful weapon in the game, aside from the grenade launcher, probably, but, whatever. Oh, God, what's happening? Okay. Sarah blocked my view for a moment. Oh, hey, he just spawned there randomly. We're gonna ignore him. We don't need to go in there. Let's go, let's go, let's go. So there's gonna be two molded in here, but if you just do this, you can ignore them. Push this little minecart, and then we're going into the final save room, I think. I think final save room? Oh, hey, get out of here. I think second class, final, whatever. Probably easier when just go. Alright, heading up. Ignoring that. And then here we go. This is the room where you find out all the secrets. Like, if you care about the story, this is where all the secrets are. But I already know all those bullshit, so I'm just gonna do what I need to do. I basically need to make an antidote. Or a vaccine that will kill Evelyn. And Mia gave me a little vial, which is Evelyn's tissue sample. So I put it in. It's going to go into that creepy fetus. And then it's going to go in that creepy fetus and spit out E neurotoxin. And that will be what we use to beat Evelyn in the end. So that's bullshit. Here's the save right over. I thought there was a save in here. Or maybe it's this room. Yeah. So we're going to save. Take down Evelyn. It's our last mission objective. One little small section that we have to deal with. Flamer rounds. I guess we can take more of those in case we need them. I guess we do have to fight the fat guys. The idea is that we're going to try and avoid the fat guys. Because they're a huge time suck and I want to not deal with them. So basically, once I get into that area over there, there's going to be two big guys that spit acid. The goal is to stun them or to... oh no, I have to go through a whole gauntlet first. Usually I would have Nero rounds for this, which are rounds that basically stun enemies, but I don't have that bullshit, so I didn't feel like going in. Oh god, go. He has no arms, so he's not an issue. Run through most of this. She's an asshole, Evelyn. So basically... Excuse me. Get out of the way. Right. If you run into an enemy long enough, they'll just get out of your way. Get out of the way. Okay. That was worth it. Okay. Wait. Did I run the wrong way? Shit. Surprise, everyone, I ran the wrong way. Big shock. I'll probably use a health kit going into the boss fight here. Oh, right. Alright, that's why the smart bombs are super helpful. So, alright. I have my rocket launcher. My grenade launcher. So the whole thing of the grenade launcher is I'm hoping, unless I get lucky, I didn't bring any knife. Okay, if I can get lucky, I can knock both of them down with one shot. And up I go. Let's see if we did it. Ah, fuck! I almost made it. Fucking ass. Alright, so that, now I have to kill them. I just waste so much fucking time dealing with them. I'm really upset about that. Now I have to deal with them. I only had one shot to get up there, so... Thankfully, this is on easy, so it's not the end of the world. Like, that guy just died from one grenade launcher round. He's bigger, though, so he takes... a little bit more, and I only have the magnum. I'm using health here, because why not? I mean, they're the last real enemies of the game. There, he's down. Okay. So, yeah, I mean, it didn't cost too much time, but it cost enough for me to... I think he's down. No, he's not. That's annoying. No, he'll hit me off the ladder that's what just happened when I tried. There we go. Right? Jesus Christ. Fuck my ass. The hit detection doesn't even register if you're standing. Wasting so much time. Did I blow his head off? Oh my god, it takes so much ammo. So much ammo to kill him. Eh, I got burned. Sweet. Waste more time because of the animation. Here, let's try and bring him down. We're good. I think that got him. Yeah, I hear the music, so we're good. So that wasted about 2-3 minutes. But, I mean, this is it. That was the final real enemy of the game. So now we just gotta fight Evelyn and then we're done. I think that's the final enemy, like, legit enemy of the game. So now we just gotta take out Evelyn. You would think, you need to deal with Lucas again, but Lucas doesn't show back up throughout the rest of the game. That's it. The one time you dealt with Lucas. This is the final save of the game here. I'm gonna put this up. Because, why not? I love how they give you a mic map to the mine after you've just come out of the mine. Makes total sense. Okay, so final section of the game. Oh no, where's Grandma? So we're back in the house. We're back where we first met Evelyn. No, so like this again. This last half of the game is just rail shooter bullshit. You have to wait until these visions are done, which is annoying. And then we're gonna go confront Evelyn in the attic. And then that will be it. Hey, remember when that happened? That was fun. Remember when I had an axe? How awesome that was? Now I don't have no axe no more.
This is your fault.
I don't know what that means. You know, why is it my fault? What did I do? But maybe at the end, you'll see. Maybe there is a reason it is my fault.
You shouldn't have done that.
Well, no, there's another thing, but I mean, I don't know if I want to spoil it right now. But
does it want to be my daddy?
That's Evelyn. That's the whole point of the whole point of this game is Evelyn.
It's mommy's turn to kill you.
But I think you have to interact with fake Mia a couple times in order to activate final Evie. Or maybe she's over here. I don't remember. I could have swore she was upstairs, but maybe. Oh, there's okay.
I'm not playing.
So now there's an annoying part coming up. Oh, you're fake. You're not real. I have to go now. Okay, I had to trigger that in order to go up to Evelyn, because fuck me for trying to save time. So now when I come upstairs, I'll be able to take down Evelyn. I think so. So, like I said, Mia is not real, so we're going to come around here and believe Evelyn is through this door. Damn it. It must be the other way. There's Evelyn. All right. So she's going to shout at me, and I need to block it. Okay. So that's her thing. I need to block whenever she's about to do her sonic boom. Okay. And that will get me closer to her. There we go. That was good.
No.
One cycle, pretty much. Well, two cycle. Not bad. All right. So now the final fight, which... No, that is not my daughter. She is a bioweapon that they created. It was Grandma all along. Oh, my God. Who would have thunk it? So basically this fight, the final boss of the game, is you just need to shoot her a bunch. That's literally it. You just need to shoot her a bunch. It's helpful to have the machine gun for this final fight, because it's not really like more damage you do. It's like you got to keep her away from you, pretty much. Just wait. So there's items behind me, but I don't think I need them. Once we get to phase two, the game's pretty much over. All right. So there's her face. So there we go. I think it's two clips and then we're good.
Bow.
I should use the special ammo, but whatever. Yeah, that's weird. Yeah, I died. Huh. Yeah. Yeah. My first death at the final boss. That pisses me off, because that honestly, like, the machine gun, you don't, it's just one clip. And that's it. So I'm a little pissed off that did not kill her. I guess if I had the shotgun, it would have gone faster.
But you didn't move out of her way.
You're not supposed to. You're stuck in the room. Like, she keeps coming. You're supposed to hit her a bunch until the second phase starts. So, I guess this is... a good lesson in that the Magnum actually really sucks. Is not a good weapon. The shotgun is your best bet for everything, even though it is only two shots. I do have special ammo, so I'll try that. This is where I'm... Oh, fuck. I could have gone through the whole game without dying. But, yeah, well. Yeah, thanks. Alright. I'll pick these up. Why not? I don't know if I'm supposed to hit her in the eye, but... I mean, I'm doing everything I can. Oh, there we go. All right, phase two. So I just wasn't using the right ammo. My bad. So now this is the final fight of the game, the very, very final fight. And I think we're going to be way underestimate, closer to like 3 hours total. That's 30 minutes earlier than what I had planned. Alright, there's Evelyn. Hi. Hi, Evelyn. This fight is pretty much like a rail shooter fight. There's not much you can do. I mean, you're laying on the ground.
You're just a little boy.
Ow. Did that reload my gun? Probably not. Oh, it did. Okay. Oh, there's nothing you do. I don't even think you can heal. You can just shoot at her. Okay, there's the next phase. So she's gonna pick me up and then I need to shoot at her while I'm being in the air. Usually you have the machine gun for this, it makes it go by a little bit faster, but well, did it reload?
I just heard you got bad knee.
Nope. Oh my god. There we go. Alright, now this is it. This is the final thing, because there's an even powerful Magnum laying there, given to us by a mysterious stranger. So he's going to tell us to use it, which is the same exact Magnum I'm already using. But whatever, this one's magic. Because game. That's why. Okay, this one has a laser sight too, which the one I had didn't have, which is a bummer. And that's it. And that's it. So that's Resident Evil 7. Yeah. Yeah, the Magnum you get when you beat the game only is 3 shots. But you get 4 extra shots for the end boss. There's Evelyn. Goodbye, Evelyn. And I think if I did my timing correct, we'll be at 3 hours or a little under 3 hours, which is pretty cool because the world record for this game is an hour and 38 minutes, I think, currently, or a little under. So I'm only an hour, a little over, or not even. Yeah, I'm a little over just like an hour of the world record for this speedrun, which is kind of cool. Like, I thought is an hour and 40 minutes, I think. So yeah, I got the achievement. Complete the game within 4 hours. It's official. Woo! There it is. Done. I don't know. Maybe. Well, I'll watch the replay. I'll download it and watch it. But I don't think it shows up on there.
No.
Okay, so I got the achievement that says I beat it in under 4 hours. And here's Redfield.
3% of gamers.
Nice. Redfield. I don't know if that's Chris. He's not beefy enough to be Chris Redfield. So I don't think it's Chris. Alright, so that's Resident Evil 7.
Took you guys so long?
So I don't think you can...
The fuck took you guys so long?
Yeah, Ethan's weird. Can I skip this? Yes, sorry. Biohazard!
Resident Evil 7
Biohazard. Basically, the end is Ethan gets taken away on a helicopter with Mia. 2:45! The official time. Only restarted once, so that's a bummer. Didn't get any coins. I read 4 files somehow on accident. I used 19 healing items. That's a lot more than I thought. So yeah, that's it. That's now we unlock the circular saw and X-ray glasses. So the next time I play, I will have those available. And then this is the DLC that will be coming out for this game. So yeah, That's Resident Evil 7.
Woo!
Yeah, thank you, Mike. That's Resident Evil 7 in 2 hours and 45 minutes. It is possible. It's actually pretty easy to do. Anyway, this was fun. I'm glad I did this. I'm kind of done with Resident Evil 7 for now, though part of me wants to do this on Madhouse, which is basically limited saves, limited healing items, and all that, but I don't know if I'll do that. But, yeah, that's it for Resident Evil 7 in 2 hours and 45 minutes. It is possible. If you are, you have this game and you want to try it out, you can totally do it. It is completely possible. So, thanks again for watching. Mostly Mike. Shout out to Mike Brewhauser for watching the stream and for I guess this will inspire him to eventually play Resident Evil. And if people are watching, he said he's going to play it, I think. Oh, he's listening while he's playing. Well, I hope this didn't spoil anything for you, Mike.
Unless he was straight up lying.
Yeah, but yeah, so that was fun. I'm glad I did it way underestimate. It was about like 40 minutes under than what I thought it was going to be, even with two major fuck-ups. Yeah, and yeah, so that is Resident Evil 7. I hope people who watch this either now or if you're watching the YouTube version of this find some useful things out of it.
Hello.
And yeah, I hope that I'll do more of this kind of thing. If Mike especially wants to watch more Twitch streams, I'll do it for Mike. And maybe I'll do some Overwatch streams at some point or something. I might do this on Madhouse and stream some of it. I don't know. We'll see. I'm kind of done with Resident Evil 7 for now. I might stream Witcher 3. Maybe I'll stream some Witcher 3 at some point. But for now, I am done. So, mostly Mike, since you're the only one watching, I think. Have a good day, and I'll see you later in the futures.